So right friends, we'll just straight away start a discussion. So previous class we had started discussing in detail the various ideas under Ind AS number 16, which deals with your property, plant and equipment. We saw as to what exactly constitutes property, plant and equipment. We saw the basic capitalization guideline. We also touched upon the ideas relating to depreciation, and that is what we had kind of stopped. And of course, towards the end, I was dwelling upon something to do with your revaluation model. The revaluation model, when we were looking at, we saw that an asset cannot be revalued, the entire class has to be revalued. The policy has to be applied for the entire class of assets. You cannot restrict yourself only to one or two assets. Having said that, different classes of assets, we can choose different methods of carrying amount, whether we want to prefer or whether we prefer a revaluation model or a cost model is entirely left to us. Nobody can come and stop us, but we can pretty much follow cost model for one class of assets and revaluation model for another class of assets. And then we saw something to do with your revaluation. So we'll just continue the discussion on the revaluation. Again, do remind me, I need to discuss the scope of the standard, something about bearer plants very particularly. We'll dwell upon that towards the end of this class. So when it comes down to revaluation, the core structure of revaluation, or what exactly was a bunch of accounting that we did earlier, under the erstwhile AS number 10, and whatever you are supposed to do right now, one change only. Which implies we are going to stick to the same old logic, first time revaluation, subsequent revaluation, previous revaluation, loss or not, all those kind of logic will pretty much kick in right now. So I think you can definitely contribute this one. So accounting for revaluation, renda pirjipo, first level, first time revaluation, and subsequent revaluation. So first time revaluation, what will happen guys? If there is an upward revaluation, we call it as a revaluation gain. And accounting for revaluation gain, debit what? The asset, and credit revaluation surplus. Now, here we'll be making very, very small change. Ultimately, you'll be crediting only to revaluation surplus. That's a given. So where exactly would revaluation surplus appear? You'll find that credits to revaluation surplus will be routed through something called as other comprehensive income account. A small little statement that we need to get exposed to at this particular stage. Normal AS or traditional income statement was always comprising of only one item, P&L account. Under your Ind AS scenario, you'll find that the P&L account kum balance sheet kum nadulla, we are just trying to bring in two small statements. A kind of successor solla kodadhu, kind of sequel to your P&L and a prequel to your balance sheet madri, there are two statements that are getting introduced. P&L account odiya or segmenta, you will have something called as other comprehensive income. Balance sheet or prequel, you will be having something called as statement of changes in equity. So look at any of the Ind AS based financial statements, you'll find that these guys are typically having four elements. P&L account has got basically two parts, the traditional P&L and something called as other comprehensive income. We'll just quickly look at that idea and then move on. The structure of financial statements under Ind AS. What exactly is the structure here? Traditionally, we have income statement, the P&L account, a statement of profit or loss. And then we had the balance sheet, the position statement, the balance sheet, the standard. You'll find that in the income statement, there are two segments right now, the basic P&L statement and something called as other comprehensive income. Inga, you will typically book all income, expenses, losses, gains, everything will come down here. And other comprehensive income will end up routing what? Any gains, losses, etc., which cannot be routed through P&L account. That would be routed through other comprehensive income. Revaluation surplus is a classic example. Revaluation surplus, so revaluation gain, for instance, is a gain for sure, a gain which is accruing or arising in a current year. But this cannot be credited to P&L account for the simple reason being this is not your traditional operating gains. As a result of which, typically we used to straight away credit that one to revaluation surplus. A reader of financial statement never knew that one at all. Asset increase purchase nanchipa. Very few people will actually get into the so-called reserve schedule and figure out that there is an increase in revaluation surplus. That kind of confusion was pretty much there in the erstwhile scenario. The IFRAC, IFRAC International Federation of Accountants, these guys realized all these kind of follies of the old set of statements, and they realized that even those kind of gains should appear as part of income statement, but let us classify them separately. Which implies you will get to know that whatever gains are there as part of your other comprehensive income is predominantly a book or notional gain, but it is a gain in the current year. Current year gain ingiradala current year OCI la vandrom, and they'll tell the shareholder that paathukoda idala, these are not cash gains, these are more like a notional gains, and therefore this cannot be routed through your income and expenditure account as we would normally do. That is all. Likewise, in balance sheet, we typically have the balance sheet as a precursor. You'll find that statement of changes in equity, and then you'll be having the balance sheet. The end of the middle, you'll be having schedules to balance sheet also, where we'll be having schedule for reserves. Like I'm splitting the income statement into A and B. Technically speaking, balance sheet A and B are very important. That would be very inappropriate. But what I'm just trying to drive home here is that balance sheet ku munnadi there will be one more statement. One more statement is nothing but statement of changes in equity. Statement of changes in equity is nothing but the summary of all reserves and their movement. What was the opening balance and reserve? What was the additions made during the year? What was the reasons for the additions? What are the deletions or transfers? What is the reason for such deletions? Which implies revaluation surplus. We will say current year we have credited, let's say, 200 rupees. 200 rupees will appear in other comprehensive income. The same 200 will once again appear in statement of changes in equity. And classify pannirpom. Revaluation surplus, add current year revaluation gain 200. You're able to follow here. OCI speaks only about what is happening in the current year. Statement of changes in equity essentially cares about what? Opening balance, current year changes, closing balance. You're able to appreciate the underlying principle, guys. This is what will happen under statement of changes in equity. Revaluation surplus varudhu appadina, you cannot just like that credit that one to P&L and leave it open. At this stage, we need to understand that this so-called surplus should be routed through other comprehensive income. Merely because I'm routing it through OCI doesn't mean that I'm crediting to P&L account. It only means that I'm crediting to revaluation surplus account. And current year, whatever extent I'm crediting, I want to show that one to my uses of financial statement. You're able to follow that logic, guys. Therefore, OCI valiya root pannanungaradhu rule. So whenever there is a revaluation surplus, you'll be routing it through OCI. Are we good to go, guys? Any confusion here? Shall we? Next. Likewise, any downward revaluation, we'll identify that as a revaluation loss. What exactly would be the accounting for revaluation loss? Credit PPE account, debit what? Let's be very clear, no concept of OCI in this case. As a general rule, keep in mind, you'll be routing something through OCI only if there is a notionality attached. And notionality in general we associate more with gains than with losses. I'm not trying to allude or I'm not trying to convey that losses can never ever be routed through OCI. Pinnadi paapom adhu nadakkum. But the timing, let's be very clear that loss varudha, you'll be debiting that one to P&L. Gain varudha, you'll be crediting that one to revaluation surplus. Any changes to revaluation surplus can be routed only through OCI. That's all. Clear, guys? Everybody? This is verbatim repetition of whatever we had seen earlier. Oru changing kadaiyadhu. Except the fact that I'm throwing this idea called as OCI, there is absolutely no change as against whatever you have been learning in the past. Are we good to go, guys? Everybody here? Then, subsequent revaluation. The subsequent revaluation is where, at least at the IPCC level, there used to be huge amount of activity and nariya questions like exam ku vandirukom. We'll just try to recollect this idea, guys. Inga naal scenario we can typically visualize. Is it not here? Currently, current revaluation results in gain irukalam, loss irukalam. Net effect of previous revaluations is gain, loss. Illaya? These are four scenarios that will typically have. You recollect all these ideas? Previously gain, currently loss. Previously gain, currently gain. Previously loss, current gain kind of logic and all. Same thing that we are going to document here. In the cases, what exactly would be the accounting, guys? Whenever there is a gain currently, we'll definitely debit what? Debit what here? Anama? PPE. Inge no change at all. You will be debiting property, plant and equipment for sure. A gain, the gain automatically should result in increase in the carrying amount of the asset, therefore it will be debiting only the BP. Fair enough. Credit what? Hello, sir. Nama. First case la revaluation surplus account. Second case la. Yes. P&L account in excess of whatever previously recognized loss matana can go to revaluation surplus. For the time being, just to try to understand the four broad scenarios, we'll look at each of the scenarios independently. So first scenario is pretty simple, guys. There was a gain, I'm adding more amount of gain. The extra gain will go and sit on top of revaluation surplus, not a problem. Second scenario, enna solrom, previously there was a revaluation loss. What did I do with revaluation loss? We debited that one to the P&L account. So previous loss was debited to P&L account. Current year, when there is a gain, you have to understand that a portion of this gain is essentially reversing the previous loss. 100 rupees asset 80 nu korachinta 80 90 rupees aa maarrudhu. This 80 becoming 90 is not gain, it is more like a reversal of a previous loss. Therefore, to the extent of losses that were recognized previously in the profit and loss account, I'll be crediting only to P&L account. Over and above that gain, if at all there is a gain, over and above the previous loss, if I'm making a gain, that extra gain alone can get credited where? To revaluation surplus. You're able to follow that logic, guys? Everybody here? I think I'll be having a very proper example in a while, but I would like you guys to take in the core logic alone. Ideally, the previous entry is getting reversed as the base IDR. Excess reversal should be credited to revaluation surplus. The extent of excess reversal mattumna can be routed through OCI. Because that is where revaluation surplus comes into picture. Is not then. Previously lost, currently lost. I'll knock off that one. So debit what? Debit P&L account. Credit? Oh, the BP account. I think it's a done deal. Previously lost, currently currently lost, previously gain. Now what will happen? Debit revaluation surplus to the extent of what? Revaluation surplus balance that we have. Beyond that, you are still having a loss, you please debit that one to P&L account. Once again, once there is a change in revaluation surplus, that change should be routed only through OCI. Last time credit pannama OCI la, now we'll be debiting that in OCI. That's all. Any change in revaluation surplus will be routed only through OCI. OCI is more like the channel through which changes to revaluation account is going to happen. Any kind of change should always be first presented here and then summarized later. Is it clear enough? Everybody, guys, shall we proceed? So we'll just quickly document the core scenarios alone. Please follow, guys. In another scenario, paatham 2A. Previously gain, now also gain. Simple logic. Debit BP account, credit what? Revaluation surplus account to the extent of gain. Ilya, in the gain, current gain, whatever we are having right now. Then 2B, previously loss or previously gain, loss, now gain. Now what will we do? We'll say debit PP account to the extent of current gain. Credit what here? P&L account to the extent of, I'll put it as net previous loss. Standard la the word use pannala, but inference is only that way. What exactly is net previous loss? We will document shortly. And then credit revaluation surplus account, technically speaking, balancing figure. We'll come down to that idea separately. Then 2C, previously what is that, the gain, no loss. Now what will happen? Debit revaluation surplus account to the extent of balance available, sariya, or net amount of loss. Then debit P&L account, balancing figure. Then guys, credit PPE account to the extent of current loss. Ida would be the net scenario. And the last scenario is the simplest one again. 2D. What is that, guys? Previously loss, now also loss. So previously loss in the account, therefore debit P and L account, credit PPE account. How much? To the extent of current loss. This is the scenario that I would like you guys to focus. This is the core or very important one is the middle one, 2B and 2C. Because that is what I think is worth even testing in the examination. The 2A and 2D is basically a bloody joke, bad joke. So the 2B and 2C is the one that I would personally consider as far more critical, especially 2B, not even 2C. 2C is also relatively plain Jane. 2B is where I think we are looking at certain amount of activity, which is what we will be touching upon right now. Sridhar. Now comes a question relating to your 2B. 2C again I do consider as a relatively sober scenario, romba complicated illa. We'll just focus only on 2B alone. 2B matum we'll just have a bunch of examples. Shall we? Proceed pannalama yaar? Yes? Now. Two B enna sonno. Previously loss. Now revaluation gain. In the background vechindi we'll just operate. So I'll just go with a small example. I would like you guys to pitch in at every stage in terms of numbers, computation and all. But I would like you guys to follow the logic. I don't want you people to write down anything. Take in the logic, that is far more adequate. Don't even waste your time writing it down. Logic only paathukonga seridappa. Because I would be touching upon two aspects here. Effect of some change and all. We'll see that anyway. Let's take for a moment that on 1st of April 2000 say 17. Sariya? Asset purchased for rupees 10 lakhs. Right? Estimated useful life is say 10 years. Residual value is rupees 2 lakhs. In the background la we are operating. Estimated useful life is 10. Residual value is 2 lakhs. It's all automatically done. So far so good. Now that this is over, what exactly will be the annual depreciation? SLM agenda, rupees 80,000. Standard on a case is how 10 lakh minus rupees 2 lakh is 8 lakh is technically referred to as a depreciable amount. We all understand that one. That divided by the useful life of 10 years. So automatically that would result in 80,000 rupees annual depreciation. So far so good. So we'll just go ahead and look at this idea. 1/4/2017. Cost 10 lakhs and financial year 17-18 kind of depreciation 80, financial year 18-19 kind of depreciation 80. Let's say that therefore net balance on 31-3-2019 is equivalent to rupees how much? 8 lakh 40. Now here I would like you guys to notice the first important point. When will you do the revaluation? Logically, revaluation will be done only for the purpose of proper presentation. Presentation of an asset will arise only when you are going to prepare a financial statement. Therefore, common sense demands that revaluation can be done only as at the reporting date. Exactly 31st March, ne kaathala evano revalue panna maatan. These guys will typically start the revaluation sometime in the January or February. The numbers at the asset time could be used as at 31st of March itself. That is how any sane person would typically proceed, which implies before you do the accounting for revaluation, you should have charged depreciation on that asset till that particular date. Logically, people would typically try and do the revaluation at the end of the year. Having said that, notice carefully, nothing in standard prohibits you from doing revaluation in the middle of the year. Onnum prohibit pannala. There are entities which are doing like as from 1st of October. N number of reasons are there. But therefore, at least from an examination point of view, it is always typically end of the year. Always assume, always focus only at the end of the year, which implies depreciation. Mudichittu revalue panna. Or put it more properly, whenever you want to do the revaluation, ascertain an account for the depreciation till that date based on the existing policies. Idu mudichada, no, let us assume that there is a revaluation loss. Right? I'm just assuming a revaluation loss of say somewhere around 2 lakh rupees. Assumed number tha adu. Finished. Assumed number would be equivalent to rupees 2 lakhs. Therefore, what exactly is your new balance on 31/03/2019? New balance is the shoe company. Yeah. So, new balance on 31/03/2019. I think it is pretty much on par with all these other high-end brands. ASICS, Adidas, Puma and all. I think one of the largest sports brand. Right, guys. So 31/3/2019 NAP, I got the 6,40,000 rupees worth of balance after the revaluation has been done. Now tell me what exactly would be financial year 19-20 gana depreciation year. Enna number irukum? We will typically follow the same logic, prospective effect, 6.4 lakhs, revised number minus 2 lakh, the original residual value, assuming that still continues, divided by how much? 8 years. Why 8 years? Remaining useful life happens to be only 8 years as from the date on which revaluation has been undertaken. Are all of us on the same page as far as this computation is concerned here? Ingeda kuzhappa irukada pa? Anybody? Right, super. So what's your number here? 40? 55,000. So we are having 55,000 rupees across 2 years, and therefore let's identify the net balance on 31/3/2021 is equivalent to rupees 5,30,000. Now let us go back and figure out a number. Now there is a revaluation gain. Revaluation gain happens to be 1,80,000. Right? Debit asset. No confusion. To the extent of a gain, we should obviously debit only the asset account, therefore not a problem. I am putting it that way. Therefore, new balance on 31/3/2021 would be equivalent to 7,10,000. Okay. Now the question right now is, where will you give the corresponding credit? Entire 8,80,000. So why? Because previous loss was around 2 lakh rupees. And the logic correct illiya. அது தப்புங்கறதா ஐ ஜஸ்ட் வாண்ட் யூ பீப்புள் டு ரெகக்னைஸ் தி ஐடியா என்னன்னா பட் ஃபார் தி ப்ரீவியஸ் ரீவாலுவேஷன் லாஸ் வாட் வுட் ஹேவ் பீன் தி பேலன்ஸ் டுடே பட் ஃபார் தி ப்ரீவியஸ் ரீவாலுவேஷன் லாஸ் வாட் வுட் ஹேவ் பீன் தி பேலன்ஸ் டுடே இஸ் தி லிமிட் அப் டு விச் வி கேன் இன்க்ரீஸ் தி கேரியிங் அமௌண்ட் அண்ட் டெபிட் அண்ட் கிரெடிட் சாரி கிரெடிட் வாட் பி அண்ட் எல் அக்கௌண்ட் இன் எக்ஸஸ் ஆஃப் தட் ஒன் should be routed or credited only to revaluation surplus account, which implies, I am telling you, don't focus only on the extent of loss and extent of gain. Focus on extent of net loss. அதான் நான் வந்து முன்னாடி போட்டிருந்தேன். நெட் லாஸ் ஏன் அப்படின்னா, by reducing the carrying amount 2 years later, we have also effectively reduced the annual amount of depreciation that gets debited to the P&L account. Correct-ஆ இல்லையா? Which implies my net effect in P&L account is getting offset on account of the lower amount of depreciation also. And therefore, net effect cannot be 2 lakhs. Eh? Net effect is bound to be something other than 2 lakhs. What exactly is that? We'll just look at this idea, sir. Notice pannunga ippo. Without previous revaluation loss, what would have been the carrying amount on 31/3/2021? Enna irundhukom? We are having like 8.40 lakhs, 6 lakh rupees, 1.60 lakhs. Yeah, 2 year depreciation, 6 lakh. Correct, Adappa. My balance would have been 6,80,000. Once again, without the previous revaluation loss, my balance as on 31/3/2020 would have been 6,80,000 rupees. Now, how significant this particular number is, please notice. Now 31/3/2021 mattum focus pandren. This is the current balance, existing balance. How much is that? We had some number, 5,30,000, right? 5,30,000 straight away, evlo amount of gain paathom? 1,80,000 is the total amount of gain. This happens to be therefore 7,00,000. This is also so far so good. Now we are just trying to figure out what would have been the balance on what date. This would have been balance. I don't know how you present that one. Would have been balance. And would have been balance upon the what exactly is your amount? The path of your number 6,80,000. So inference enna appadina appa previous revaluation loss illati today the asset would have been only rupees 6,80,000, which implies logically speaking today you would have revalued a 6,80,000 asset to 7,10,000. Puriyada netta? Therefore what will happen? This 30,000 goes to revaluation surplus and this whatever number 1,50,000 will go where? P&L account. We are able to follow this logic, guys. That's why I am telling you the net effect of your previous revaluation loss is not 2 lakhs, it's only 1,50,000. This can be explained also. Everybody explained 2 lakh was the loss. What's the savings and depreciation for the last 2 years? 80 has become 55,000, which implies every year there is a saving in depreciation to the extent of 25,000 rupees. 2 lakh minus 50, but 150. Edo or logic follow pannango, it doesn't matter, but I want you guys to take in this core principle. Merely because there was a previous revaluation loss of X and current revaluation gain of X, don't assume that the current X would straight away get credited to P&L account. Idha oru todarchiyana strategy follow pannalam. For example, if you plan to revalue your asset over 3 years later, today itself we can do a revaluation loss. 3 years later, we can do same amount of revaluation. You can credit that to P&L, nobody will even notice. You're technically overstating your P&L account on account of activity which is logically not even correct. But anyway, when it comes down to your actual application or examination application, stick to this one. Solder point for your there. முன்னாடி நடந்த லாஸ் இல்லாட்டி எங்க போயிருக்கும் அதை வச்சு தான் வில் கோ அபவுட் இவாலுவேட்டிங் தி ஹோல் இன்ஃபேக்ட் தெர் இஸ் ஒன் தெர் இஸ் அ வெரி ஃபேமஸ் இன்ஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆர் திங்க் அபவுட் திஸ் இன்சூரன்ஸ் காம்பன்சேஷன் தட் தே வுட் தி பீப்புள் ஜென்ரலி கிவ் இன்சூரன்ஸ் காம்பன்சேஷன் லிட்டிகேஷன் எல்லாம் சம்திங் அபவுட் ஹேட் ஐ நாட் பீன் டிஸ்டர்ப் ஹேட் இட் நாட் பீன் டிஸ்டர்ப் வாட் வுட் ஹேவ் பீன் தி கோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஆக்ஷன் அந்த மாதிரி I'm not sure how many of you heard this particular theory, but that can at some level be related to this one. The the background or story and something like this, they actually nadandhudunga somewhere in UK, but I'm not completely sure. I have heard only the story, I've never heard the actual case at all. It's about a cargo ship which is going in a typical inland waterway madri, which is not like in India, it's yet to become popular. அம்பூர்ல தான் வந்து ரிவர் சர்மெண்ட் எசென்சியலி ஃபார் ஒன்லி லைக் ஆல் வேஸ்ட் டிஸ்போசல் பிளேஸ் நாட் அ டிரான்ஸ்போர்டேஷன் பிளேஸ் ஸோ லெட்ஸ் யூகேஓ யூரோப்ல வேறவர் தர் ஸ்மால் ரிவர்ஸ் தீஸ் கைஸ் ஆர் சென்டிங் கார்கோ ஷிப் ஆர் கார்கோ வெசல் தட் கோஸ் த்ரூ அ ரிவர் போகுது அண்ட் தெர் ஆர் குவைட் அ ஃபியூ ஷிப்பிங் வெசல்ஸ் ஆல்சோ நிறைய பீப்புள் ஹூ யூஸ் லைக் ஸ்மால் ஸ்மால் வெசல்ஸ் ஃபார் ஷிப்பிங் இன் நான் ஸ்டாப்பாக பாயிண்ட் இருக்கு தி கார்கோ வெசல் அஸ் அ டார்கெட் இட்ஸ் 3 டேஸ் இட் ஷுட் கவர்ஸ் சம் அரௌண்ட் 300 கிலோமீட்டர் சம்திங் லைக் தட் ஒரு ஷிப்பிங் வெசல் ஒரு நாளைக்கு வந்து இடிச்சு கொடுத்து இட் 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 ராம்ட் இன் டு தி கார்கோ வெசல் அண்ட் தேர்ஃபோர் ஒன் ஆஃப் தி சோ கால்டு பம்போ மோட்டாரோ வாஸ் டேமேஜ் அண்ட் தேர்ஃபோர் இன் தி சேம் பிளேஸ் இந்த பிளேஸ் வேர் எவர் தி டேமேஜ் ஹேப்பன் தி நியரஸ்ட் கோஸ்டில் தி கார்கோ வெசல் ஹேட் டு பி டாக்ட் ரைட் ஷிப்பிங் தட் ஸ்மால் போட் விச் ரேம்ட் வாஸ் ஃபோர்ஸ் டு பே தி மணி ஃபார் தட் லாஸ் வாட் எவர் லாஸ் தட் ஹட் ஆக்சுவலி ஹேப்பன் அண்ட் தென் வாட் ஹேப்பன் there was this cyclone anike cyclone edho one sushuthi varume paakkuradhukku what is it twister mari irukku madamalla adhik enna edho one something happened in that particular town and it sunk the entire cargo vessel so cargo vessel is no longer present it's totally gone so the cargo company transportation company went to the insurance company to make a claim saying that the cyclone nala endu poiduthu appadinte insurance company, do you think they would have paid the money? They did not make the payment at all. They clearly said that is only for losses during transit. This is loss during station. Why did you even station there? Therefore, I am not even liable. So, case perisa poche, these guys lost. They said that you should not have stopped there. My thing is only for transit. You park point, there is not even part of your scheduled plan. Therefore, I cannot even compensate your loss. And who will compensate the loss for the entire cargo? Now, the itchan theriyuma vandu puriyudha ava it's more like cycle fellow ramming into a Rolls Royce and Rolls Royce is parked cyclone la like cycling kaano Rolls Royce kaano the cycle fellow will be hauled up to compensate for the Rolls Royce logic was very simple if you did not come and hit me I could have avoided this loss puriyudha So the so-called would have been scenario is a legally established principle. நீ வராட்டி இது நடந்திருக்காது. Therefore, if something is happening because of you hitting me, then you bear the entire loss in the number. That's a very legal an idea which is very popular, wherein they will say as to what could be or what should be considered as the cause. So in that example, whatever I was giving you, the court had ultimately held that the loss was attributed to that cyclone. It's a natural disaster. It is basically on account of you. But for you, I would not have even docked my so-called vessel in a particular place. But for the revaluation loss, what would have been my balance as on the date of subsequent revaluation? That becomes my benchmark for the purpose of accounting. Clear it up, everybody, guys? Now, I'll just tweak this idea shortly, but before that, I would like you guys to document the number alone, whatever I am just having it here. This alone. Right, so the whole point right now is something like this. So without previous revaluation loss, what would have been the carrying amount? 3103-2021. Logic in a solar, therefore, to the extent current revaluation loss, current revaluation gain takes the balance beyond rupees 6.80 lakhs should be credited to revaluation surplus. Balance of revaluation gain alone should be credited to P&L account. Idam principle. Clear here? Everybody, guys? Everyone here? Shall we proceed? Yes, I'm just scrolling it up. I would like you guys to make a note of the example alone and the workings that I had below. Kindly mark it as very important. As you write it down, you get any kind of doubt, please get them clarified. I do consider this idea to be extremely critical for us to proceed quickly here. Because same concept will be applying later as part of impairment loss and its reversal logic as well. Therefore, it is imperative that we do get to know whatever we are doing here first. Everyone, shall we? Is there doubt regarding here? Shall we proceed here? Yes. So to consider this one as pretty important. It's only in the event of a previous loss and subsequent gain that there is this whole confusion. Anyway, there was a previous gain and subsequent loss. In that case, to the extent of balance in revaluation reserve is a direct indicator. Therefore, not a problem. Are we good to go, guys? Yeah, which implies like you cannot obviously reverse more than whatever is there in the revaluation surplus. That would automatically give you the extent to which you have to debit revaluation surplus. Are we good to go, guys? Everyone here? Yes? Now, the treatment of balance in revaluation surplus. What do we do with the balance in revaluation surplus, guys? It is not eligible for dividend is something that we all understand. It is not eligible for absorbing any of the losses also we understand other than the revaluation losses. Ella okay. Are we supposed to touch the revaluation surplus balance? Yeah. How many of you are aware that there was previously a guidance note on treatment of revaluation reserve? This guidance note on revaluation reserve went about suggesting a scheme of accounting whereby they stated that revaluation upwards results in higher depreciation without there being any higher cost. Correct? Extra cost illama, there is bound to be higher amount of depreciation. Therefore, to the extent the higher depreciation or incremental depreciation, what will happen, guys? Transfer from revaluation surplus to once again other equity through OCA only. That is, debit revaluation surplus, credit reserves, free reserves. Notice carefully, don't credit P&L account. Credit where? Free reserves. We call that as other equity or other reserves. Now again, the end of Puriya, this was something which was there even in the old guidance note. They are simply saying that revaluation surplus, you are not supposed to keep it idle. Previously, as part of the guidance note, this particular accounting was an option. Entities may decide to transfer the excess, entity can as well keep quiet. Which implies many cases, people used to keep quiet because the revaluation surplus will be huge. Automatically, the balance in equity will also be pretty huge. Now, these guys are saying that, the extent you are going to charge additional depreciation, you should compulsorily transfer from what? Revaluation surplus to free reserves. Other equity compulsory transfer panniye theeranum. Puriyadha everybody guys? Yeah, this is a mandate. Now let us just quickly look at an example here and then we will proceed further, guys. Everyone? Once again, I'm just giving this example. This example will develop also as a question as far as I am concerned. A Limited acquired an asset same on, let's say, 1st of April 2017 for rupees 10 lakhs. Useful life is 10 years. Salvage value is 2 lakhs. Therefore, what is annual depreciation? That is rupees 80,000. Let us just follow the same model. So what happens is that 2 years later, the asset is revalued upwards, let's say by 1.50 lakhs. Sariya, at that time, the remaining useful life was let's say revised to 5 years. இதான் பேக்ரவுண்ட் தட் ஐம் ஜஸ்ட் ட்ரைங் டு ப்ரெசென்ட். 5 வருஷமா குறைச்சி விடுறோம். இன் தட் கேஸ் வாட் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி வுட் பி தி அக்கவுண்டிங் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட்? ஃபைர் என் ஆஃப் கேஸ். ஸோ லெட் அஸ் லுக் அட் தி ஐடியா ஹியர். காஸ்ட் ஆன் 1/4/2017 இஸ் கிவன் டு பி 10 லேக்ஸ். ஃபினான்ஷியல் இயர் 17-18க்கான டெப்ரிசியேஷன் எவ்வளோ கொடுத்தேன்? 80. ஃபினான்ஷியல் இயர் 18-19க்கான டெப்ரிசியேஷன் 80. தேர் ஃபார் பேலன்ஸ் ஆன் 31/3/19 ஹேப்பன்ஸ் டு பி திஸ். So add revaluation gain all over 1,50,000. Therefore, new balance on 31/3/2019 is equivalent to 9,90,000. So far, so good. So what exactly would be the financial year 19-20 kind of depreciation? How much? ₹9.90 lakhs. மைனஸ் ருபீஸ் 2 lakhs தானே, 2 lakhs டிவைடட் பை 5 இயர்ஸ். பை 5 இயர்ஸ் அன்னைக்கு வி ஆர் ரீவிசிட்டிங் தி யூஸ்ஃபுல் லைஃப் ஆல்சோ. தேர் ஃபார் 5 இயர்ஸ் நம்பர் 1,58,000. முடிஞ்சதா எவ்ரி ஒன் கைஸ்? தேர் ஃபார் வாட் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி வுட் பி தி ஃபினான்ஷியல் இயர் 2021 கான டெப்ரிசியேஷன்? ஜஸ்ட் டு கம்ப்ளீட், 158. லெட்ஸ் சே பேலன்ஸ் ஆன் 31/3/2021. ஏதோ ஒரு நம்பர். சோ ஃபார் சோ குட். நோ, லெட் அஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் சார். ஃபோக்கஸ் ஒன்லி ஆன் ரீவாலுவேஷன். 31/3/2019 அன்னைக்கு டெபிட் பிபி அண்ட் கிரெடிட் ரீவாலுவேஷன் சர்ப்ளஸ் ஹவு மச் அமௌண்ட் ஆஃப் மணி? 1,50,000. நோ வி ஆர் ரெக்வயர்ட் டு டிரான்ஸ்பர் ஃப்ரம் ரீவாலுவேஷன் சர்ப்ளஸ் டு ஃப்ரீ ரிசர்வ்ஸ். இன்னைக்கு 31/3/2020 debit revaluation surplus and credit other equity free reserves. How much amount? Hello ma, where did you get 78,000? 1,58,000. Can somebody correct me as to tell me what exactly is the mistake in that number? 78,000 gerdha tappu. Can somebody attempt at why is that a mistake? So apart from upward revaluation, useful life is also undergoing a change, which implies the annual depreciation of 80 has become 1,58,000 because of two reasons: revaluation gain and shorter useful life. Whatever is attributable to revaluation gain alone should be transferred to free reserves. The simple answer, 30,000 rupees, neera pon pointer kala. But I'll give you a explanation for the same also. Enna solluvom, we will say, but for the revaluation, what would have been the normal depreciation? Evlo irundhirukum? 8.4 lakhs minus rupees 2 lakhs, correct thana? Sorry, minus ne varudhirukum. Ama correct da, minus rupees 2 lakhs whole divided by 5 years. Anni girigira carrying amount minus the salvage value divided by 5 years. How much is that number, guys? 1,28,000. Sariya, which implies without revaluation gain, The depreciation would have been how much? 1.28 lakhs. And with the revaluation, the depreciation is rupees 1.58 lakhs. Therefore, in artham, additional rupees 30,000 attributable to revaluation. Here we can transfer. Ullo complicate pannanuma venda. Revaluation surplus balance irukla. Revaluation surplus how much? 1.50 lakhs divided by 5 years, same rupees 30,000. Whichever logic that you want to follow, please follow. The second one is quicker. First one is the explanation. First one the logic, second one is the simpler solution. Everyone, this is mandatory. Previously, this model of accounting where you can route it through, you don't have to transfer from revaluation surplus, no longer exists. Clear, Ayar? Everybody, shall we proceed, guys? I just want you people to take in this principle alone. Clear then, Ayar? Any doubts at this stage, guys? Anybody here? Shall we proceed, Panlama? Yes? No. Extending further. On 31/3/2021, the balance in the books will be as follows. PPE account. How much did we see here? 6,74 lakh debit balance. And then credit balance would be your revaluation surplus account. How much would that be? 90,000. Every 90,000 rupees. 1.5 lakhs minus transfers rupees 30,000 into 2. Correct? So the balance on 31/3/2021 would be equivalent to 90,000. Correct, Aliya boss? Everyone? Now, at this stage, asset is sold for rupees 6,80,000. What will be the accounting entry? Another accounting entry, 6,80,000 with that. Debit, cash and bank. I'm nudging into or entering into something called as derecognition. Debit, cash and bank. How much amount? 6,80,000. Then credit, PP account. How much is that? 6,74,000. Then Nama, credit, gain on sale, 6,000. அப்படி இல்லாட்டி டெபிட் ரீவாலுவேஷன் சர்ப்ளஸ் 90,000, therefore gain should be 96,000. இது கரெக்ட். This, whatever you see on your screen or this, which one sir? 96,000, 6,000. Yes please. Traditionally, the accounting used to be something like this. 90,000 rupees, what was unrealized gain is right now becoming a realized gain and therefore will be credited to P&L account. Today, you will find that, this is correct, independently one more entry, credit what here, other equity. Thaniya. Appo enna solran, thalaye ponalum seri, balance and revaluation surplus can never ever be routed through your P&L account. Summary prayer da yaar. Everyone clear ah guys? Yes. So before we proceed any further at this stage, any point that you want me to clarify? Anybody? No, it can. I didn't consider that one. So revaluation pandranala scrap value impact ahadengra assumption la edhum kediyadhu. Because once you take up, let's put it this way, once you take up the activity of revaluation, you are going to assess not just whatever the asset is worth today. You'll also be assessing how many more years it can actually survive, what could be the expected salvage value. Ellame you'll be revisiting. But only to the extent current day balance is increasing or decreasing, you'll call that as a revaluation gain or a loss. Not any other reason. So scrap value will be revisiting. Another example consider pannala, but that does not affect my accounting treatment. Puriyadha? Why should I do it? Yeah, that is the starting point. Revaluation you always do as at a particular date. And the so-called 30,000 is attributable to a particular period. The period obviously happens only after a particular date. So, adhukapram I can do the accounting. 30,000 rupees transfer cannot happen on 31/3/19. It can happen only after that, because that's the date of revaluation. Clear? Anybody else, guys? Solda ma. Okay. What do you want me to have as a number? Sorry. Take it. So what will be the accounting entry? என்ன இருக்கும் டெபிட் கேஷ் பேங்க் 5 lakhs பிபி அக்கௌண்ட் 6 lakh 74 டெபிட் லாஸ் ஆன் சேல் 1 lakh 74 1 lakh 74 thousand ஃபினிஷ்ட் நோ சேஞ்சஸ் சப்சிக்வெண்ட் என்ட்ரி பாயிண்ட் என்னன்னா தி பேலன்ஸ் இன் ரீவேல்யூஷன் சர்ப்ளஸ் ஷீல்டட் ஃப்ரம் தி வாட் எவர் கெயின் ஆர் லாஸ் ஆன் அக்கௌண்டிங் தட் யூட் அதர்வைஸ் டு You're able to follow the underlying point, guys. தலையே பிச்சுக்க மாட்டா ரீவேல்யூஷன் சர்ப்ளஸ் தலையே பண்ணாலும் தொட மாட்டேன் அது அப்படியேதான் இருக்கும் அங்கேருந்து பேலன்ஸ் ட்ரான்ஸ்ஃபர் பண்ண போறேன் தட் பேலன்ஸ் will go only to other equity. It cannot come into my P&L account at all. Clear ஆ யார் எவ்ரி ஒன் கிளியர் தானே பாஸ் எனிதிங் எல்ஸ் கைஸ் எனிதிங் எல்ஸ் தட் யூ வாண்ட் மீ டு கிளாரிஃபை கைஸ் ஷல் வி ப்ரோசீட் எஸ் ரைட் Now there are two sub-ideas that we would be touching upon. Once again, we'll be revisiting the idea relating to revaluation surplus. I'll just give you a quick hint as to what would be the bunch of sub-ideas that we'll be touching upon. And then we will run through those two ideas. Romba kutti idea tha, we'll tackle that. One is the subsequent cost. Next is the subsequent change in the provision for decommission. Friend. Subsequent cost, subsequent change in provision for decommissioning. These rendu we are required to touch upon. What do we do with subsequent cost, guys? Can we capitalize? We did discuss this one yesterday. Once again, can we capitalize? Yes, can be capitalized. Right? Enna condition? We may have to de-recognize whatever is sought to be replaced. Nyamarka on the depreciated value. How to compute that too? We had seen. The provision for decommissioning is always based on a discounted value. Obviously, that net discounted value are required to keep on increasing so that the actual liability is carried. This is a possible reason. Again, any other reason? Correct? Correct? I assumed initially that the expected cost for dismantling decommissioning would be 10 crores. Today, it is becoming 8 crores. I am assuming right now that the cost is a bit more favorable. It will be more favorable. It will be possible. Then, lastly change in market interest rates I went about doing the entire accounting based on a bunch of discount rate today's scenario is such that I may have to use a higher discount rate abdina what will I do the moon scenario we are just trying to split first scenario accounting is very very simple what's the accounting guys unwinding of discount will always result in increase in liability correct right what do we do debit finance cost credit provision account you remember I told you very specifically that when it comes down to provision for decommissioning you'll always debit only your finance cost interest cost amount dhaan treat pannuvom the meedhi rendu irukku illa idhukku dhaan standard gives a slightly different reason they say that boss there can an increase in liability or there can be a decrease in liability randomly possible follow this example carefully and then we will tackle any case accounting depends on the model or carrying amount model which the entity follows or the model a base panni accounting will happen people there are only two possibilities the present value of provision amount can increase or it can decrease ஏதோ ஒன்னு ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணுவோம் அங்கேயிருந்து வில் ஜஸ்ட் கோ அபவுட் டாக்லிங் தி அதர் ஏரியாஸ் என்ன வச்சுக்கலாம் இன்க்ரீஸ் வச்சுக்கலாமா டிக்ரீஸ் வச்சுக்கலாமா number increase in liability. If there is an increase in liability, we will be crediting what? Right, debit what? Debit what guys? No. Finance cost kadaiyadhu. Finance cost comes into picture only for unwinding of discount. Discount pannanala time value panni consider pannirukkeengala. Therefore, you should debit finance cost. You cannot do that debit right now. Any guesses? Napa? Why asset account, sir? Whenever there is an increase, we should add that one need to asset account. Anybody wants to contest him? His point is very simple. Aarambathil enna panna liability, discount panni, you debited that one to the asset. Now, when the liability is increasing, you should once again debit the same amount to the asset. That's a fair thing to do. Anybody who wants to contest that? Enna tappu irukku adhula? Correct. Correct. இன்னைக்கு அன்வைண்ட் ஆகி தான் வந்திருக்கும். So let's say that initially 10 crore was discounted to 3 crores and capitalized. Today, before all this change happens, 3 would have already become 5. 5 will become 6. One crore they are going to recognize, not 3. Clear? And that gets depreciated over remaining period. That's not a problem. Anybody else, guys? I told you that time itself, asset being ready for intended use, a general cutoff. There are multiple cases where you'll end up increasing the carrying amount on account of even without incurring a subsequent cost. This is one such example. Anybody else? Anybody guys? Papa? Yeah? No. The specific scenario is dealt in detail in the standard itself as part of Appendix A. Appendix A or next year, Appendix A. Please have a look at that. காஸ்ட் மாடலுக்கு எனி இன்க்ரீஸ் இன் லயபிலிட்டி யூல் ஆல்வேஸ் கோ அபவுட் டெபிட்டிங் தி அசட் அக்கௌண்ட் ஃபார் ஷியோர். ரீவேல்யூஷன் மாடலுக்கு என்ன சொல்றேன், பிளீஸ் டூ ஃபாலோ திஸ். ரீவேல்யூஷன் மாடலுக்கு வாட் டு தே சே? இங்க இருக்கிறப்ப ஒரே நிமிஷம். If the related asset is measured using revaluation model, change in liability will what? Enna kuduthirukku? Alter the revaluation surplus or deficit previously recognized on that asset. Which implies, under revaluation model, it would not be fair for you to touch the carrying amount of an asset. Because carrying amount of an asset is driven by the fair value. Fair value can be independent of your so-called, you know, residual salvage value, all those kind of things. அது தனியா வச்சுக்கிறோம், தனியா இருக்கு. Which implies whenever you are carrying the asset using a revaluation model, increase in liability, credit provision, debit whatever, you should be debiting revaluation surplus account if there is a balance in revaluation surplus account. If there is no balance in revaluation surplus account, what will you debit here? நேரா P&L account. Loss அப்போ உட்காந்துக்கும், அசட்ட டச்சே பண்ணக்கூடாது. Puriyartha everyone guys, you are not even supposed to touch the asset because asset today carrying amount is a reflection of fair value. Idhiyum adhi please link pannadinga. You are able to follow what I am driving at here guys? Everyone here? Yes. Therefore, so debit what? In case the entity follows cost model, debit the PB account. In case the entity follows revaluation model, debit revaluation surplus account to the extent of balance available. Seriya, debit P&L account to the balance sheet. Are we good to go guys? Everybody here, whenever there is an increase in liability, this is what your accounting is all about. Inga edha kolapam iruka? Everyone, market is important. Quickly make a note, hugely important. திருப்பி சொல்றேன், தி ஹோல் சினாரியோ இஸ் செப்பரேட்லி ட்ரீட்டட் அண்ட் கன்சிடர்ட் அஸ் பார்ட் ஆஃப் யுவர் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட். இண்டே 16ல அப்பெண்டிக்ஸ் ஏ கோஸ் அபவுட் வெல்லிங் இன் டீடைல் ஒன்லி அபவுட் திஸ் ஐடியா. தனி விச் இம்ப்ளைஸ் லைக் லாபமா அப்படியே ஒரு க்வெஸ்சன் டெஸ்ட் பண்ணலாம். தெர் கேன் பி அ க்வெஸ்சன் டைரக்ட்லி ஃப்ரம் திஸ் ஐடியா அலோன் ஃபார் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் லைக் 8 மார்க்ஸ். வித்வுட் மச் ஆஃப் அ டிஃபிகல்டி திஸ் கேஸ் கேன் டெஸ்ட் அ நியூ ஐடியா விச் இஸ் சோ அப்பேரண்ட்லி விசிபிள் இன் யுவர் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் இட்செல்ஃப். ஃபாலோ பண்ண முடியாதாப்பா? ஹவ் ஆர் வை இட் இஸ் கிரிட்டிக்கல்? குவிக்லி டாக்குமெண்ட் திஸ். And then we will look at what would be the scenario if there is a loss. As in, decrease in liability. Can somebody tell me, okay, this is for the other points under your so-called increase. What kind of reservation should anyone have before debiting this amount to the asset account for cost model? In a reservation account here. Well, let's say that I am your client and I debited a hefty amount to the so-called asset account. From the point of view, what do you think should be the serious factor that needs to be considered? For a factor, every debit to an asset account is subjected to the conditions of recoverability. Sariya, if you think that by having this additional amount, the so-called recoverability is suspect, in that case, you are not supposed to debit that one to the asset account. That's a standard thing. Idhikin thaniyaya kadiyadu in general. I'll put it this way. Or asset today worth happens to be 5 crores. Please follow the entire logic. Asset today worth happens to be around 5 crores. The current carrying amount of the asset is 4.50 crores. Which implies carrying amount right now. Cost model, carrying amount is lower than the worth, not a problem. Which is absolutely correct. My carrying amount should not exceed the asset's worth. This is logical and our conclusion. Due to this kind of fancy accounting, I am right now forced to debit the asset account. And therefore, carrying amount is increasing from 4.5 crores to 5.3 crores. Moment it goes beyond 5 crores, then I should be cautious. I cannot debit the entire 0.80 crores to the carrying amount because 30 crore extra, 30 lakhs, that is not recoverable because my worth itself is only 5. Therefore, 30 should go only to where? P&L account as a loss. இது என்னைக்குமே ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கோங்க whenever there is a question of capitalization of any number of any cost or any number to the asset comes into picture, one question that you should throw at is what? Whether this amount is recoverable. To the extent it is not recoverable, to the extent it is more than the recoverable amount, please don't debit the asset account at all. That goes to the P&L account. Clear here? Everybody guys, clear? We'll just document that also. Other points technically one day one day. If the debit to asset account is deemed unrecoverable, that is, it takes the carrying amount what here beyond the recoverable amount, the excess should be written off to P&L account. Example, A Limited carrying an asset at rupees 4.50 crores under cost model. Sariya, recoverable amount, that is the asset's true worth, is rupees 5 crores. Due to change in provision for decommissioning, let's say that the increase in liability is rupees 0.80 crores. Enna pananum? Yeah? Credit provision account, how much? 0.8. Debit PP account, 0.5. Debit P&L account, 0.3. Reason puriyar then enter? Yeah? Yes? Why are we debiting only 0.5 and not 0.8? Because once you debit 0.5, it takes the carrying amount to 5 crores, which is okay. Adha thandi carrying amount pokudadu. Never ever, no, change your carrying amount beyond your so-called the asset's true worth. Are we good to go, guys? Everyone, idhi ezhudhi konga. Once again here, this entire segment do consider as pretty important. Quick. Practically, we are done with this entire standard. We just go about solving all the remaining questions. This is the major idea. Nothing else is worth testing in my view. Everything else is so very mundane and sober that these are the ideas that is actually quite critical in the overall scheme of things. Shaldapa. Your book value itself is wrong enough. That is what we call it as an impairment loss. Let's say in the instance of the carrying amount being only 4 crore. All the entire this 0.8 crore will go to P&L. In addition to that, you will also recognize impairment loss of 0.5 crores. So we are yet to even reach that idea. This is enough. Clear, guys? What if there is a decrease in liability? Now what will happen, guys? When there is a decrease in liability, debit provision account, credit what? In case the entity follows cost model, credit asset account. Having said that one, Can the credit exceed the carrying amount? It cannot and it should not. Puriyuradha? My carrying amount of an asset is only 4 crore. Decrease in liability is 5 crore. Quite possible. Sir, yeah. But because provision thani. And therefore, you will realize that you cannot credit an asset beyond whatever balance is there. Asset cannot carry a debit credit balance at all. Enna pannu, sir? Excess will be credited to P&L account. In fact, I'll put it this way. Can the credit be such that it reduces the carrying amount below the residual value? My example there, full on notice pannunga, right? Balance in provision is rupees 10 lakhs or rupees 100 HPO. Sariya? Balance in asset account is around 85. Some number. Don't assume that provision should be always lower than balance in asset account and all. Towards end of an asset's useful life, you will find that the provision can be higher than the so-called provision itself, I mean asset itself. Balance in asset is 85. Residual value for asset is, let's say 60. Idam background here. Case A. Provision decreases by rupees 10. End entry. Debit provision 10. Credit asset 10. Prachane kadaiyadu. Very clean. Because after passing this accounting entry, carrying amount of asset will come down to what? From 85 to 75. Still okay. Case B, provision decreases by rupees, say 25. Once again, debit all over, provision 25. Credit what here? Asset 25. Still not a problem. Why? Carrying amount is reduced to residual value. Residual value is the lowest possible carrying amount that you can have for an asset. Correct? Case C, provision decreases by rupees 38. Debit provision 38, credit asset 25, credit P&L account 30. You're able to follow the idea, guys. So, end point, any decrease in liability will definitely go about reducing the carrying amount of my asset, but the reduction cannot be such that it takes the carrying amount lower than the residual value. If at all it takes it that way, the extra amount should obviously be credited to your P&L account. Clear the everyone, guys? Yes? Everyone? The document Bandikonga Raja, including that example, then we'll focus on revaluation model quickly. Which one? It can be. No, you're missing the point. Residual value estimate. Okay, I'll put it this way. You are making an estimate that residual value is 5 lakhs or 5%. 5 lakhs or kodi rupees asset. Today, when there is a decrease in what? Provision. Adhu or estimate dhane. If the estimate to the reduction and in the estimate on dhaniya vacharukum. There is bound to be a conflict because these two are independent. This is based on cost and what price I can sell. In the estimate is whatever will be required to incur. In the future, in the reduction nala, idhukku against a pogalaamangaradha question right now. Puriyadilla? My provision is an obligation. I'll be required to spend, let's what, 85 lakhs or whatever number. And I'm expecting that 85 will come down to 40 or some number. A decrease pannanungaradhu correct. Provision has to be reduced. But that's a reduction in obligation. Residual value is a reduction in, or residual value is a estimated the recoverable amount. Adhu keela pogakoodadhungaradha basic point. The two opposite side, don't try to link. My, tomorrow the company might decide that the residual itself has gone down. We are not even bringing that into picture. That is separate. Clear, guys? Yeah. Carrying amount of the asset. Carrying amount only for asset. Dismantling cost is the provision. Yeah. Clear, guys? Everyone here? Any guesses as to what would be the accounting treatment if there is a revaluation being done for that asset? You obviously you cannot touch the asset account. What will you do? அவ்வளவுதான். கிரெடிட் யுவர் ரீவேல்யூவேஷன் சர்ப்ளஸ் அக்கௌண்ட். இஃப் அட் ஆல் தெர் வாஸ் அ ப்ரீவியஸ் ரீவேல்யூவேஷன் டெபிசிட், கிரெடிட் யுவர் பி அண்ட் எல் அக்கௌண்ட். கிளியர் தானே கைஸ்? நோட் பண்ணிட்டாச்சாப்பா எவ்ரி ஒன்? ஸோ இன் கேஸ் தி அசட் இஸ் கேரிட் யூசிங் ரீவேல்யூவேஷன் மாடல், தென் வாட் டு வி டூ? டெபிட் பிபிஇ, சாரி டெபிட் ப்ரொவிஷன் அக்கௌண்ட், கிரெடிட் பி அண்ட் எல் அக்கௌண்ட் டு தி எக்ஸ்டென்ட் ஆஃப் நெட் ரீவேல்யூவேஷன் டெபிசிட் இஃப் எனி, ரைட்? கிரெடிட் ரீவேல்யூவேஷன் சர்ப்ளஸ் அக்கௌண்ட், தட்ஸ் ஆல். வாட் இஸ் ஆல் த டியூ அண்ட் ஐ ஆர் சப்போஸ் டு டூ, ஞாபகம் ராஜா. ஸோ தேட் வுட் நோ ப்ராட்லி put an end to your discussion relating to your Ind AS 16 on PPE. There are like kutti kutti ideas which we'll probably touch upon as part of discussion questions, but conceptually we don't have much beyond this. So at this stage, before we start solving any question, any point that you want me to clarify, guys? Yes, please. Solunga ma. Very simple. And the mela so first time loss subsequent gain paathom illaya, அதே லாஜிக் தான். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம் தர் இஸ் அ லாஸ் ஆஃப் 2 lakhs அண்ட் தர் இஸ் அ ரிடக்ஷன் இன் டிப்ரிசியேஷன், நெட் ஆர் அமௌண்ட் இருக்கும் பி அண்ட் எல்ல விச் வி ஹவ் ஆல்ரெடி டெபிட்டட் இன் தி பாஸ்ட், சேம் திங், அப்சல்யூட் நோ சேஞ்ச். மீன் இது டெக்னிக் எப்படின்னா சேம் அஸ் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டைம் ரீவேல்யூவேஷன் லாஸ் அண்ட் சப்சிக்வெண்ட் ரீவேல்யூவேஷன். ப்ளீஸ் கெட் டு நோ திஸ் ஐடியா கைஸ், திஸ் என்டையர் செக்மெண்ட் இஸ் அ பிராண்ட் நியூ அடிஷன் to your standard. Because over and above this one, there are other kutti kutti points such as the financial cost should always be excluded into. If at all there's a deferred payment terms for purchase of an asset, you should never ever consider the deferred payment as part of the cost, because deferred payment can also include interest element. Adalla basic ana vishayangal adallamo we'll be seeing. Once again guys, before we actually start solving some more questions, at this stage guys, I want you people to quickly give me any point that you want me to clarify. Beautiful question. So what if my decommissioning liability is measured in forex? Anybody? Yeah. See, on a standalone basis, anything other than unwinding of discount should be routed only to this kind of model. Other we will not be calling it as an exchange rate gain or exchange rate losses. Anga rend element irukku, is it the effect of foreign currency change or is it defect of this one? But when it comes to defect of this side, it will be treated only as effect of change in decommissioning liability. Other than then you don't have any choice at all. But in general, provisions are not based on forex, in general at least. It is like fully estimated ascertained liability mattum da monetary item a treat pandrom, as a result of which, as a rule, to the extent that I understand, most of the people don't even carry provision based on forex. Irukum, but ultimately estimate will be driven only by a random number, and the estimator romba frequent a thada mattaanga. Let's assume for a moment that decommissioning liability, you do assume that 10 years later some German company should come and do. You assume that there will be like, you know, a million euros or 6 or 8 crores that you'll be spending. And the 8-ingra number odiye chepa exchange rate maaradanaala provision maatha maatam as a rule. Aarambathla estimate pannumbodhu il project some number, leave it at that. Every year we will not keep on revisiting the exchange rate. Appa kuda varadengra na, till that point at it is only a provision illa, is it not? Because the exchange rate gain le paarengla, these guys go about the spreading between monetary and non-monetary item. Monetary items la or definition they will say in fixed and determinable sums of money in bar, the definition of monetary item, and your provision is not determinable sums of money, that is an estimated amount illa. So how typically happens, I'll estimate 8 crore 8 end of crores, I'll project also today's exchange rate is 80 85, interest rate differential nala it can become 95 rupees edho sonni project panni will compute a number, and that would pretty much remain at that level. I will not every year keep on revisit that one in general, unless there is a spike in the foreign currency amount itself. I estimated $1 million, now it is becoming let's say $1 million+ abdina, then I will revisit. Related for a provision in general, people don't go about looking at the latest exchange rate, of course, unless there is a very volatile change. Related vadi illa volatile change, you have to, because there is bound to be serious implications. Yeah, anybody else guys, you will understand this point here? I am measuring the decommissioning liability by translating the cash flows from Forex to Indian rupee. In that case, should I consider this kind of model for what? Exchange rate fluctuations. So I made 2 points. Even for decommissioning liability, which is estimated based on a foreign currency outflow, we should pretty much follow the same logic if there is an exchange rate losses. But having said that one, as a rule, provisions are not subjected to restatement based on exchange rate fluctuations. Reason, these are not in the nature of what we call it as a monetary item, very purely because monetary item lo kuduthirukkira precondition is that the carrying amount reflects the amount at which will be settled. Fixed and determinable sums of money at which it will be settled in the round. Our amount called as provision is not meeting the description at all, as a result of which generally we will not revisit a provision due to any kind of exchange rate fluctuations. Again, this is a very general prescription. Having said that, if the exchange rate fluctuations are expected to be so huge, a 40 rupee to a dollar is right now becoming 75 rupees to a dollar, it makes sense for you to go and revisit that number. Still the same logic. You cannot do anything else at all. You will not call that as exchange rate losses. Clear, guys? Solupa. Correct. இன்னைக்கும் present value பார்ப்போம், but today's present value. சரியா? You will not go back to time zero. Today's present value. Correct. 100% correct. Are we good to go, guys? This is what is the base for question number 15, question number 16. And the bunch of revaluation discussion that we had is covered under question number 17. And then we have question number 19, which deals with exchange of assets. In the items full, I would like you guys to try. Go ahead, guys. 15, 16, 17, 19. 4 questions I would like you guys to try. Proceed further, please. So, right, guys, do we have a bunch of numbers here? Yeah? We'll just quickly have a look at question number 15, then we will follow it up with other questions. A building was constructed at a cost of 240 lakhs on a leasehold land. That in itself is a dead giveaway that since you're constructing on a leasehold land, that to a building, there is bound to be something about decommissioning. Idella hint basically. I'm ready aayikanum paatha odane. The land lease was for a period of 6 years. At the end of the lease, land was to be handed over in the condition in which it was initially given, free of all the construction. Initial estimate of cost of demolition was expected to be 30 lakhs. And a suitable discount rate pegged against the prevailing treasury bill rate is 10%. Forget about all the fancy English these guys are using. Bottom line, discount rate 10%. Advise accounting for the 6 years. So we are required to advise accounting. You are essentially required to pass the accounting entry. That is all you are supposed to do. So what would be the number, guys? The initial recognition. How much? Debit. The building and leasehold land account. Whatever, building a PP account. However, how much? 240 tappu. So cash, bank, vendor, whatever you can call it as, is 240 lakhs. Credit, provision for decommissioning, rupees 30 lakhs divided by 1.10 power 6. Clear? Present value of the decommissioning liability. How many of you did not consider decommissioning liability at all? Consider it. Asset was capitalized only for 240 lakhs. Anybody? How many of you did not do the discounting here? Anybody? How many of you got the discounting wrong? 16.93 ku badala number. You, what mistake? என்னவோ மிஸ்டேக் பண்ணிருக்கோம், அதுவே என்னன்னு தெரியல நம்மளுக்கு, இல்லையா? அது பயங்கரமான மிஸ்டேக். அது என்ன மிஸ்டேக் பண்ணோம் தெரியலன்னா கஷ்டம் தான் அது. எனிபடி எல்ஸ் ஹியர், எனி அதர் நம்பர்ஸ்? ஐ ஜஸ்ட் அகைன் வுட் லைக் டு நோ வாட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் மிஸ்டேக்ஸ் வி ஆர் மேக்கிங். இட் டஸ் இட் ஜஸ்ட் ஹெல்ப்ஸ் மீ இன் அட்லீஸ்ட் வார்னிங் யூ சப்சிக்வென்ட் பெஸ்ட் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ். எனிபடி வேற எந்த மாதிரி தப்பு பண்ணோம்? ஒரே ஒரு வருஷம் டிஸ்கவுண்ட் பண்ண ஆசாமியாரா? அது டிவைட் பை 1.1. ஓகே, I think these are broadly the kind of things that anybody le vera vidyasam thappanina solungada. within these four walls, all kinds of mistakes we can make. Vella ponna da kashtam. So broadly, these are the numbers that we have, and therefore, initially capitalized amount would be 256.93. So please do mention that the present value of decommissioning liability should also be treated as cost and capitalized as part of the initially recognized amount. Sariya? Clear then, guys? This is what we have been touching upon even in the previous class as part of capitalization. Next is all your unwinding of discount and depreciation basically. So we'll just focus on the unwinding of discount and depreciation. Again, tani compute panni entry potala seri or mothama entry potala seri, nothing is going to matter. I am just doing the computation and entry separately just to ensure that I get the proper set of numbers. I'm leaving it to you, but bottom line is something like this. Unwinding of discount enna irukka porudhu. So we'll find that the year's opening balance in provision, then interest at how much percentage? 10%, then guys, closing balance in provision. Clear? We'll just straight away start. Year number one, what is opening balance in provision? 16.93. Interest at 10% would be equivalent to 1.69. By the way, which brings me to the another idea. I saw quite a few of you writing in all these 8 digit, 9 digit central. You round it out to thousands or lakhs. Because like more decimals or more digits that you're going to use, சிலநேரம் மறதியில் ஒரு ஜீரோ மிஸ் பண்ணிடுவோம். 80 க்ரோர்ஸ் இருக்கும், வில் ரைட் 80 கவுண்ட் பண்ணுவோம். இந்த எழுதும் போது வில் சடன்லி ஸ்டார்ட் ஹேவிங் டவுட் வெதர் க்ரோர் இஸ் ஹேவிங் 6 டிஜிட்ஸா 7 ஜீரோஸா 6 ஜீரோஸ் ஆன்ட்டு ஒரு ஜீரோ மறந்துடுவோம். நீங்கள் மிஸ் பண்ணுற ஜீரோவை எக்ஸாமினர் போட்டுருவான், நாட் ஒர்த். ஸோ தெர்ஃபார் ப்ளீஸ் ஐ வுட் சஜஸ்ட் தட் ஆல் திஸ் ஹியூஜ் நம்பர்ஸ் யூ ஸ்டே அவே. We are not dealing with taxation, right? We are only dealing with accounts. We just need to focus on the accounting. The clerical aspect about number, correct decimal digits, not worth it. Right? Examiners don't reduce mark for all that I know. They don't reduce mark at all for these kind of things because avane compute panna count pandrathukku tired aaduvaanga. Adhu edhukku. Therefore, you're better off by rounding it off. That is absolutely okay, Raja. Round off thooki perusa round off pannadhenga. Then you please do some decent rounding up. You don't round off like lakhs to put the question and let me round off to crores and put on the good here, please. Lakhs and lakhs would have come. Some kind of reasonableness is what is expected of you. So 1.69 lakhs closing balance in provision, therefore 18.63. Second year, same story. Third year, fourth, fifth, sixth. So this would be the bunch of numbers. In the interest of the number, unwinding of discount. So in here, often we get tired. I'm just suggesting a model. Again, I'm not even personally sure if this would be okay. But I do strongly believe that examiners should not be denying you mark and all. So every subsequent year, what will happen, guys? Yeah? What? Finance cost account at R2. ப்ரொவிஷன் அக்கௌண்ட் ஹவு மச் அமௌண்ட் இயர் ஒன் இயர் டூன்ட்டு காலம் நேரில் மொத்தம் முடிச்சிடுறது பெட்டருங்கிறது மை பாயிண்ட். இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் ரைட்டிங் சிக்ஸ் அக்கௌண்டிங் என்ட்ரிஸ் யூ ஜஸ்ட் புட் தட் அண்டர் சிக்ஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் காலம்ஸ் அண்ட் ஃபினிஷ்ட் ஆஃப். சரியா ராஜா? ஹவு மச் வி ஹேவ் ஹியர் ஆல் தீஸ் அமௌண்ட்ஸ் யூ ஜஸ்ட் ப்ளீஸ் அப்டேட் ஷூட் அப்படி ரைட். ஆசமாக போச்சு. தெரியல, விடுங்க, முடியாதா? படா, சரி வேல்யூ போடணுமா சம்திங் ஏதோ ஒன்று. மை பாயிண்ட் பீயிங் யூ ஜஸ்ட் ஜஸ்ட் பாஸ் அ காலம்னர் என்ட்ரி ஆல்சோ பிகாஸ் அட் வெரி மச் ஃபிட்ஸ் இன் அ ரிக்வயர்மெண்ட். லைக்வைஸ் யூ கேன் ஆல்சோ டு தி அக்கௌண்டிங் ஃபார் டிப்ரிசியேஷன். யூ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் டு பாஸ் சிக்ஸ் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் அக்கௌண்டிங் என்ட்ரிஸ். அக்கௌண்டிங் ஃபார் 6 இயர்ஸ் கொடுத்துருக்கேன், ஆஃபன் வீல் ஃபர்கெட் டிப்ரிசியேஷன். அது எதுக்கு போடணுங்கிற மாதிரி தோணும். யூ மே பி ரிக்வயர்ட் டு டூ தட் ஒன் ஆல்சோ. ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் டூ தி என்டையர் திங் ஒன் செகண்ட். டிப்ரிசியேஷன் அக்கௌண்ட் எட் ஆர் டூ வாட் அசட் அக்கௌண்ட் ஹவு மச் அமௌண்ட் இயர் 240 சம்திங் டிவைட் பை 6. ஸோ 48.82.82 lakhs. சரியா? So this can be done for all the 6 years. Or one number report, the same thing will be repeated for 6 years. It's also absolutely good. And without the fail, please pass the last accounting entry. A accounting for payment for dismantling. What would be this accounting here? Provision for dismantling account at R2, cash, bank, whatever account, 30 lakhs and 30 lakhs. This is on the assumption that there is no change in that amount. Your estimate is so bloody perfect that whatever number you estimated was even that eventually happened. Illiya, andha mari achana enna pannala idha pannanum. Clear guys? Yeah, everyone, election munjana, this the cephalologist and all will sit and often take pride in saying that they got a lot of these things numbers right. This time, you know, before the elections were happening, I saw some exit polls predicting seats in a range is okay. Range cannot be like so huge, illa you see exam age vandu evlo mark kadaikum appadina you can say 60 to 65, 40 to 45, 30 to 35, ஏதோ ஒரு நம்பர் சொல்லலாம். 0 to 100 ரேஞ்ச் கொடுத்தா இல்லையா, அந்த மாதிரி நம்ம ஆளுங்க பெருசா ரேஞ்ச் எல்லாம் கொடுத்தாங்க. கொடுத்துட்டு இவர் கரெக்ட்னு பெருமை பீதிக்கிறது வேற. சோ அந்த மாதிரி இல்லாம நம்ம சொல்றது எக்ஸாக்ட் ப்ரெடிக்ஷன் பக்காவா தாவூத் இப்ராஹிம் மாதிரி பிக்ஸ் பண்றது. இந்த மேட்ச்ல இந்தியா வில் ஸ்கோர் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி 320 ரன்ஸ் தான், கரெக்டா அவ்வளவு தான் ஸ்கோர் பண்ணுவாங்க. பிகாஸ் அப்பேற்பட்ட பிக்ஸிங் நடக்கிறது. தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் வி ஆர் லுக்கிங் பங்கா பக்காவா பேங்கமா பிக்ஸ் பண்ணிட்டோம். நத்திங் வில் சேஞ்ச். Clear, guys? Yeah. Then this is the base accounting here. I don't think that the subsequent stage there would have been any challenge, except the fact that we often get tired doing this entire accounting. That is a major challenge that you cannot avoid. Some of these solutions can be so monotonous that we sometimes lose interest in between itself and then move on. This is like one such question. Imposition madriye irukum. Imposition da idu actually. Seriya? Shall we? So question number 16 is the lengthy theoretical discussion that we had towards end and before we started discussing the question, which is what it is all about. Like 12th December, releasing right now. A politician who has been telling that he will come to politics for last 22 years, and he is still a part-time politician, and therefore nobody knows whether he will actually come. He celebrates his birthday today, 68 ani ki, 68 mudinji 69 something. கரெக்ட் தானே? நான் 10ஆம் கிளாஸ் படிக்கலன்னு சொல்லிட்டு இருக்கேன் யார். சோ நெஞ்சு வலிக்குது எனக்கு. சோ க்வெஸ்சன் நம்பர் 16 கைஸ், ஏ லிமிடெட் அட் எஸ்டிமேட்டட் அ காஸ்ட் ஆஃப் 1,25,000 டுவர்ட்ஸ் டீகமிஷனிங் டிஸ்மேண்ட்லிங் ஆஃப் ஒன் ஆஃப் இட்ஸ் பிளான்ஸ் அக்கௌண்டட் ஃபார் தி சேம் சூட்டபிள் இன் அக்கார்டன்ஸ் வித் தி ஸ்டாண்டர்ட்ஸ் ஆன் பிபிஇ. During the year ended 31/3/2017, company reassigned the estimated cost of such decommissioning dismantling. It seeks your advice in the following independent case. Reassigned cost of decommissioning dismantling is 1,85,000. Asset is measured using cost model and carrying amount is 15,25,000. Can somebody point out the inadequacy in this question to begin with? சால்வேஜ் வேல்யூ கொடுக்கல, இன் விச் கேஸ் வி கேன் ப்ராபப்ளி அஸ்யூம் தட் சால்வேஜ் வேல்யூஸ் நில். அது கூட பிரச்சனை கிடையாது. வாட்ஸ் அதர் மேஜர் இஷ்யூ? ரேட் இஸ் நாட் இவன் கிவன். அவன் இனிஷியலி ரெக்கக்னைஸ் அட் 1,25,000, தட் வுட் ஹவ் பீன் டிஸ்கவுண்டட். அதுவே கொடுக்கல. ஸோ இல் அஸ்யூம் என்ன, தட் அமௌண்ட் ரிமைன்ஸ் சேம், விச் இம்ப்ளைஸ் அவர் கண்ட்ரி இஸ் கோயிங் த்ரூ சம் டெரிஃபிக் ஸ்டாக்ஃபிலேஷன் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் மாடல், இன்ஃபிளேஷன் டிஸ்கவுண்ட் ரேட் இஸ் ஜீரோ அப்படிங்கிற அசம்ஷன்ல ஆப்ரேட் பண்ண வேண்டியது. வி கேன் டூ எனி திங், ஒண்ணுமே கொடுக்காட்டி வேற என்ன பண்ண முடியும்? But assume that number is fair reflection of the present value also. Therefore, guys, over case A, case A, the base enna kuduthirukka na, case A existing provision amount how much? 1,25,000. Seriya? New provision amount 1,85,000. So difference all over 60 results in increase in provision. Therefore, for sure, credit provision is okay. அவர் ரெண்டு சினாரியோ கொடுத்திருக்கான்ல, சரியா? So, let us take up the scenario. Scenario A1, என்னது? Cost model being followed. Therefore, what do we do? Debit, asset account how much? 60,000. Credit, provision account 60,000. பண்ணிட்டு, assumption என்ன எழுதணும்? The debit does not take the carrying amount beyond the assets recoverable amount. இது இல்லாட்டி solution is incomplete. இது இல்லாட்டி கூட ஃபைனல் ஆன்சர் இஸ் கரெக்ட், என்ட்ரி அவ்வளவுதான், பட் இல்லாட்டி சொல்யூஷன் இஸ் இன்கம்ப்ளீட், தேர்ஃபோர் ப்ளீஸ் ரைட் தட். சோ வென் எவர் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு டெபிட் சம்திங் சச் அஸ் திஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் நம்பர்ஸ், யூ ஆர் எக்ஸ்பெக்டட் ரைட் ஆன் அ ஸ்மால் லிட்டில் நோட் தட் திஸ் டெபிட் வில் நாட் ஆல்டர் யுவர் ரிகவரபிள் அமௌண்ட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் சினாரியோஸ். புரியறதா யார் எவ்ரிவன் கைஸ்? தென் சினாரியோ ஏ டூ, ரீவாலுவேஷன் மாடல் பீங் ஃபாலோட். And these cases are thankfully given that previous net revaluation deficit was rupees 2.50 lakhs. Accounting entry enna boss? Debit asset account varadhu, debit P&L account, correct? How much? 60. Credit provision account 60,000. Debit revaluation surplus if in the past there was a revaluation reserve. Question very clearly says that in the past there was only a revaluation deficit, therefore you can't do anything. How many of you debited revaluation reserve account here? Anybody? Question olunga padikalana artham jagrathiya irundukonga. Please ensure that when the question very clearly says that there was a net revaluation deficit in the past, you cannot debit revaluation surplus account at all. Sure sir, clear guys? Everybody here, get to learn from the mistakes others are committing here. Namm ipo panatti sellana pinnadi panni thulachiruvom. Stay forward. Right, everyone, new year resolution achupom, but new year neranga neranga lot of people have fancy resolution. The most standard resolution happens to be what? Most popular resolution, seriously, resolution oda ottir balama people will spend the money. Gymming, you know, people always go for gymming. Those guys, we call them as gym philanthropist. So kaasu kudupa pongalukku banal aidum adu, adha cover these guys will not even go 2 weeks katham. Anyway, amari ya resolution board vechukonga, something you will probably follow just to ensure that you won't repeat a mistake. That's all. Oru thappu oru thadava seiyala, rendu thadava seiyave koodadhu. Next item guys, what was the scenario? Same story. Yeah, existing provision amount kodtaache, new provision amount is given to be how much? 25,000. Difference is 1 lakh. This is decrease in provision. Sariya, fine. Decreasing provision. This is where the idea starts. Scenario B1, cost model being followed. Now what happens? Yeah, debit provision, how much? 1 lakh. Credit what? Asset account, how much? Why 95,000? Sorry, then 5,000. Sorry, clear guys? Just watch out there, if the question they also speak something about the residual value and all, you should take care of that one. In assumption and therefore residual value of the asset is rupees nil. If residual value is some number, the reduction should not take the carrying amount to less than that number. In excess of that number should automatically go to P&L account. Clear then everyone? Scenario B2. Revaluation model being followed. So same story. Debit provision 1 lakh and credit P&L account 1 lakh. So in assumption edhu illa, because the historic or past net revaluation deficit has been more than 1 lakh. Therefore, we can happily credit this number to P&L. Clear here? How many of you managed to get all the 4 answers right here? Seriously good here. Hey, endathla enna aachu? Ullo thappu? You didn't get, you didn't solve. Time will tell you what happened. Calculator le ya? Seriously, you have a phone right? Ellarume calculator vechale phone ah use pandranga, calculator illati ad use pannala illa, but in general refrain from using your phone for calculation here. I mean, not that it matters inside class, but no, you can just the habit da illa. I mean, at some level you should stop punching in numbers from calculator without even looking at the calculator. ஃபோன்ல எவ்ரி டைம் கீப் ஆன் லுக்கிங் அட் தட் ஒன். அந்த பிராக்டிஸ் வரதுக்கோசரம் சஜஸ்ட் பண்றது தான். ஐ ஹேவ் நோ ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் யூ யூசிங் ஃபோன்ஸ் இன்சைட் திஸ் கிளாஸ் as long as you get the answer right. சரியா கைஸ், ஷல் வி மூவ் ஆன்? யா, ஏதாவது டவுட் இருக்காடாப்பா இங்க? எனிபடி? ஷல் வி? கிரேட். க்வெஸ்சன் நம்பர் நெக்ஸ்ட் என்ன சொன்னேன், 17. So just quickly look at this question number 17 and then look at a very specific scenario. Barbeque Nation, a chain of fast food and restaurants, purchased a multi-purpose dishwasher for rupees 75 lakhs. What's a dishwasher here? Remember? Washing the dishes. In India, it's not that pretty popular. In fact, I've been... almost like nudging my wife to get a dishwasher so that I don't become the dishwasher, but of course sometimes we do the so vaangunont when you're discussing at home, like I'm just speaking about 4 years back, we had to buy one. The typical discussion was that, like, you know, for Indian cooking style it is not advisable at all because you have like very oil intensive, therefore it will not be really good, and you have to like literally change the whole set of thing that you have. I mean, utensils you should standardize. I was like, okay, probably we'll just gradually go towards that one. And I kept on telling that illa irukonte. Then we used to reach out to some of our friends who are in, you know, US, Canada. Avanga dhaan poi paadhi vela kaarana maari irupaanga. Avanta ketta illa prachane kedaidhu because those guys he is only bloody what is that bread sandwich adhu complete use pandrathu aniyayam basically. So ibdi odinnu irukku nambuurla dhaan enga adichu veluthu kattuvome idli saaptale. நாய்க்கு உதர நம்பர் தான் பிளேட் இருக்குல்ல, இட்லி எண்ணெய் போட்டுப்போம், தென் சட்னி போட்டுப்போம், தென் சாம்பார் கொட்டிப்போம். சம் பீப்புள் ஸ்டில் யூஸ் இட்லி அண்ட் ஜாம் அண்ட் ஆல் தோஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் அட்ராசிட்டி கைஸ் ஆர் ஆல்சோ பிரிட்டி மச் அலைவ். எல்லாம் யூஸ் பண்ணுவாங்க. ஸோ இட்ஸ் வெரி டிஃபிகல்ட் சொல்லி பீப்புள் யூஸ். ஸோ ஐ டோல்ட் தட் ஐ ஷோ யூ பிகாஸ் யூடியூப்ல தெர் ஆர் தெர் வில் பி டெஃபினெட்லி லாட் ஆஃப் வீடியோஸ். ஐ டோல்ட் ஹர் தட் நோ ஐ வில் சி யூ வாட்ச் திஸ் வீடியோ. ஸோ டிஷ் வாஷர் ஃபார் இண்டியன் குக்கிங்னு போட்டுட்டு வீடியோ ஆன் பண்ணிட்டு ஐ வாஸ் ஃபோன் வந்து கலையம் போயிட்டேன். And then she saw for like a minute or so and then she stopped. She didn't even continue watching that damn thing. Comedy bulsa kidanga. You also Google, you also go to YouTube, you search, you will find the ultimate tragedy. India is a country of jugad. Sariya? There is purpose one. Or one purpose or two purpose or two utilization visualized by the guy who is manufacturing a particular product. Namba pudusa one use pannipo. Illa? You know what was that video all about? Using dishwasher to cook. Seriously, it was not about cleaning any of the dishes at all. It was about cooking. The logic was like dishwasher uses the steam and hot water and all, and therefore using that you can use for cooking. And the mari video potest pona seriya kalai poni eduthan pondu idukla vaana appadina and the mari nadakkum adha dishwasher atrocity. இந்தியன் குக்கிங் டிஷ் வாஷர்னு யூடியூப்ல தேடினா வரக்கூடிய மொதல் வீடியோ வில் பி ஃபார் பாயிலிங், குக்கிங், பேக்கிங், வாட் எவர் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் திங்ஸ் யூ வில் நாட் ஈவன் திங்க் ஆஃப் யூசிங் த டிஷ் வாஷர் ஃபார். நம்மளுக்கு அப்படி தானே யூஸ் பண்ணுவானுங்க, எதுக்கோ கொடுத்தா என்னதுக்கோ யூஸ் பண்ற மாதிரி. தர் இஸ் ஹோல் திங்க் அபவுட் டாப் லோட் வாஷிங் மிஷின் பீங் யூஸ்ட் இன் பஞ்சாபி தாபாஸ், தெரியுமா அது எதுக்கு? லஸ்ஸி. I mean, lassi, you go to some of these Punjabi restaurants, these guys will place this 1 liter jar in front of you. You think that, okay, that is for all the 4 people on a table, only then you'll realize that 3 more jugs will come and hit your thing. So, avlo mass production of lassi pananona enna panna mudiyum? Washing machine da use panna mudiyum. Front load, obviously, you cannot use it at all. Top load, people are using. Reality. People are actually using that one because it would do left, right, all kinds of combination. It will happen here the bubble throw adikum so that it comes in a very proper texture and all the mari. Anyway, avlo super dishwasher. So Barbeque Nation is obviously buying a multi purpose dishwasher. Every big restaurant would typically try and buy one for 75 lakhs in April 2015. It was depreciated under state land method at 15% per annum. Sandosham panittu potom. In April 2017, 2 years later, the company revalued all the assets including dishwasher by 1/3. They say by one third. This by one third, does it mean upward revaluation or a downward revaluation? Why upward revaluation? Why downward revaluation? But decrease by the increase by varada. அடுத்த லைன் படிச்சா தெரிஞ்சிடும் அவர் சொல்றாரு பாருங்க ரிவைஸ்ட் டிப்ரிசியேஷன் வர்க் அவுட் ரூபீஸ் 15 லாக்ஸ் வில் ஃபைண்ட் தட் தி டிப்ரிசியேஷன் பிஃபோர் தி ரீவாலுவேஷன் வாஸ் x டிப்ரிசியேஷன் ஆஃப்டர் ரீவாலுவேஷன் இஸ் x பிளஸ் தட்ஸ் அ ஹிண்ட் தட் தி ரீவாலுவேஷன் தட் இஸ் பீங் அலூடட் ஆர் சஜஸ்டட் இன் திஸ் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் ஆல் அபவுட் அப்வர்ட் ரீவாலுவேஷன் நாட் அ டவுன்வர்ட் ரீவாலுவேஷன் ஹவு மெனி ஆஃப் யூ டிட் டவுன்வர்ட் ரீவாலுவேஷன் ஒன் இங்கே தெரிஞ்சு போச்சு எனிபடி எல்ஸ் ரீவாலுவேஷன் லாசஸ் 2 3 4 நீங்க யூ டிட் ஈவன் சென்ஸ் தட் ஆஃப்டர் தட் நியூ ரிவாலுவேஷன் நியூ டிப்ரிசியேஷன் வாஸ் கிவன் யூ ஹேட் அ டவுட் அதி மீறி இல்லையா சி அகைன் ஜஸ்ட் தெரிஞ்சு வச்சுக்கோங்க ஐ கீப் ஆன் ரிப்பீட்டிங் ஒன்லி ஒன் ஸ்டோரி யூ மேக் அ மிஸ்டேக் யூ ரியலைஸ் சம்திங் இஸ் ராங் யூ ஷுட் ப்ராபப்ளி ரீவிசிட் அண்ட் ரீலுக் அட் தி என்டையர் நம்பர் எக்ஸாம்ல சான்ஸ் ரொம்ப குறைச்சு நீங்க தாண்டி போயிட்டீங்கன்னா யூ மே நாட் ஈவன் கோ பேக் அட் ஆல் யூ வோன்ட் பி ஹேவிங் டைம் You, once you get a doubt, it's all the more critical that you go back. Once revalidate all the numbers, you are always better off that way. Illati miss panitta mudiyadilla. Illati you're looking at 6 months. Adhu theviyan paakanum illa. 6 months is not a small time period at all. Pochuna pocha avagala. Why even lose that one? When I started off my CA, I was very positive that I will clear my entire CA in 4 years. Therefore, I gave myself one extra term for IPCC or inter and one extra term for final. Start பண்ணும்போது அப்படி தான் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா ஒரு வருஷம் வச்சுப்போம் ஃபவுண்டேஷன்றதுனால 5 இயர்ஸ் ஃபவுண்டேஷன் முடிச்சதுனா 4 இயர்ஸ் கணக்கு வச்சுட்டோம் இன்டருக்கு ஒரு அட்டம் எக்ஸ்ட்ரா ஃபைனலுக்கு ஒரு அட்டம் எக்ஸ்ட்ரான்ட்டு அந்த மாதிரி இருந்தால் பரவாயில்ல இல்லை பரவாயில்ல 6 மாதம் இருக்குன்ற தினவட்டிலேருந்து ஓட்டிக்கலாம் பட் நார்மலி ஐ டோன்ட் திங்க் லாட் ஆஃப் அஸ் வுட் பிளான் ஃபார் தட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜி அண்ட் 6 மந்த்ஸ் லேட்டர் பரவாயில்ல போய் திறக்கட்டும் Because after I cleared my inter in first attempt, I told myself that now I have 2 attempts for CA final. Extra confidence la varala final edathukku paravala da apra 2 attempt irukku final ku dhairyama padikkalanu anyway question 17 odia answer guys so that's a dead giveaway that subsequent increase in depreciation is an evidence that the revaluation that this question is suggesting alluding to is only relating to revaluation losses so let's look at the idea Asset has sold for 45 lakhs. Past journal entries of financial year 1920. Nammude idea is only about 1920. We'll just look at the numbers. Solladappa. Abadiya. Endha year end pannalam. Enna koduthirukanga? April 2017 la company revalued asset. Endha year? Neenga first April potta anik revalue pannikonga. Thappu illa. See. Maaradhu. End of 17 or beginning of April 17, it does not change at all. Right? So, cost of the asset on what date, guys? 1-4-2015 is given to be rupees 75 lakhs. Then, less depreciation for financial year 15-16, 16-17 is how much here? Into 0.15, 11.25 lakhs. Therefore, net book value on 31-3-2017 or 1-4-17. You can put it here. 52.50 lakhs. Then, add revaluation gain. You can put a note. What is the note? The depreciation subsequent to revaluation is 15 lakhs higher than existing depreciation of rupees 11.25 lakhs. This implies that the revaluation resulted in gain. All of that. Therefore, add revaluation gain one third of 52.50 lakhs. 17.5. Anybody who did this one third of 75 lakhs here, I have seen that. Okay. One third of what is it? Existing book value. Right? அதே மாதிரி இப்படி 75 தொட்டீங்க ப்ரீவியஸ் ஒன்லி ஒன்ஸ் இஸ் மிஸ்டேக் ஹஸ் ஹேப்பன்ட் யார் ப்ராப்ளி ஒன்லி ஒன் கை ரேஸ் இஸ் ஹேண்ட்ஸ் பார்த்தா அப்படிதான் தோன்றது ரைட் நோ வாட்ஸ் அவுட் சரியா ஸோ 25 கிடையாது 17.5 தெர்ஃபோர் வாட்ஸ் யுவர் நியூ புக் வேல்யூ கைஸ் தட்ஸ் ஆல் So therefore, what would be the depreciation for next 2 years? Financial year 17-18 and 18-19. So 15 lakhs and 15 lakhs. So therefore was another number book value on the date of sale. Sharia, everyone, this is for asset. What exactly would be the balance in revaluation surplus? We know that revaluation surplus would be equivalent to 17.5. Therefore, ending irregular balance 17.5. And therefore, we should also reduce the extra depreciation from revaluation surplus. The question is actually about accounting in the year of sale. So, for all practical purposes, we are going to pass accounting entry only for the sale. So, we need to figure out what is the balance in revaluation surplus also. In a number rakha bol diya, minus how much? 3.75. Therefore, balance would be equivalent to 10. How many of you computed the balance in revaluation surplus and the rate of sale, guys? Anybody? Yes, please. Yaar me liya? You did. Most of you didn't even do that one. Okay. On kedgar entry 1920 la. 1920 la depreciation charge pannirukka mudiyadhu because asset was sold. The only accounting entry that we will pass would be that of a sale. Sale of a depreciated revalued asset vandurathunale, I told you earlier that we have to figure out what would be the balance in revaluation surplus. Clear? So keeping this point in mind, what would be the accounting entries, guys? Another entry for sale. Cash bank account debtor, how much? 45. Then to asset account, 40. To gain on sale, how much? 5. Illaya ithoda entry mudiyala, we need to pass one more entry. What is that? What is that, guys? For transfer of balance in revaluation surplus. Any entries on revaluation surplus account debtor to other equity? Equity podadinga, other equity reserves basically. How much? 10. 10. Chariya. Without these two accounting entries, your solution is not complete. You get only the first entry, not the second one. I would tend to believe that you may not be getting any marks. I'm not sure that I shared this one earlier. In general, you are supposed to be given step marks. But in general, most of the examiners don't give step marks. Again, you don't have to trust me. You just probably have a look at some of your answer copy that you grabbed or got from the CA Institute. Some of your friends answer copies that they would have typically received. You can just have a look at that one. You'll find that many cases there will not be any step mark at all. If the final answer is wrong or incomplete, those guys don't even give any mark. It is reality. You should only plan for reality, not for an ideal world. Worst case scenario, ready aikonga, which implies you don't get an answer right, you won't be getting any marks. Naanga padikira kalatha logic is very simple. 5 good answers evada, 6 average answers will fetch more marks. This is what was the, you know, guiding point for people like us when we were preparing. So we used to aim for average. That's all. Today, 5 average answers would basically imply that the 5 incorrect answers. And therefore, you may not be getting any mark at all. You should be getting like 4 exceptionally good or correct answers. And yaha vachina operate panikonga. A small thing, what looks like a small thing, might be huge you know, impact on your exams. Clear it up, everybody? Shall we? So this is all that we have in question 17. So before we move on to 19, any point that you want me to clarify? Anything, guys? Anybody? Clear it up, everyone? Shall we proceed? Yes? Next. Question number 19, pretty much open and shut. I didn't expect you to document any answer at all. You can just mark the answers besides your question itself. Moving on, Papa. Exchange of assets. Exchange of assets, sir, guidelines. The question is all about new asset should be recognized as follows. Everybody, at fair value. How to compute fair value? Fair value of asset given up or fair value of asset taken over, whichever is more clearly evident. Sariya, but as a rule in general, we go by fair value of asset given up. Why so? It represents cost and assets are to be recognized at cost. Seriya? Now, at book value of existing asset. Eppadi? When the fair values as above are not ascertainable. Illave illaya, the new asset will be recognized only at the book value of the old asset. In the background of which we will just straight away go ahead. Yes. Shall we? Yep. So first and foremost here, what's your idea, guys? Case A. Old asset another. Asset A. New asset is asset B. Fair market value of asset A is not ascertainable. So what does that we'll do, guys? New asset coming in. Asset A. So asset A should be recognized at what? Rupees 1,20,000. Why 1,20,000? The only fair value available. Proceed further, finish it off. Everybody, then case B. Hey, illa pa new asset. Sorry, Rama. Extremely sorry. Nagandu thella kuchh. Sariya, case B. Case B, asset B whose book value is 1,50,000, fair market value 175 is given up to take over asset A. So new asset another asset A. Old asset is asset B. So penna solrom, asset A new should be recognized at 1,75,000. That's the only fair value in the question. Thalaiya pichikavana. Onnu thaan kuduthirukana, we'll stick to that one. Next, guys. Case C. X with book value. Roll away. Book value of rupees 2,45,000 and fair market value 175 is exchanged for asset Y with 1,85,000. So asset Y is the new asset, old asset is asset X. So rendudhukume fair value irukku. Now what do we do here? Assuming both are clearly evident. The answer can change. Assuming both are clearly evident, new asset Y should be recognized at 1,75,000. That is fair value of asset given up. Sariya, idan costing karnala. Case D. Old machine having book value of 5 lakh were exchanged for acquisition of a new machine whose fair value is 15,75,000. The company paid a sum of 7,50,000 in addition to old machine. So case D, one and what upon new machine then? How much here? So machine. Clear? The machine's fair value is 15.75 lakhs. What is old asset are given up asset? Old machine and cash. So cash is also at some level an asset that you give up. But generally we don't use the term called as I'm giving up cash. We say we pay cash. That's normal and a practice. But having said that, rumba proper apata, cash is also another asset that is being given up. Is that a reality? Is it not? Yes, so cash is also given up. Keeping that point in mind. So what will be the carrying amount of case? Fair value of asset given up. And old machine kind of fair value. 6.25 lakhs. Cash is fair value 7,50,000. Cash up purta varaiku nominal value is equivalent to book value is equivalent to fair value. Correct alliya? Cash oda beauty oda illa. Nominal value, book value, fair value ella onna da irukka mudiyum. Because that's the whole point of cash. Therefore over. So na accounting entry. So new asset, a new machine should be recognized for rupees 13.75 lakhs. Clear, guys? Everyone? Then, case D2. Same story. Would your answer differ if old machine's fair value was unascertainable? Obviously, old machine's fair value is unascertainable. Therefore, new machine should be recognized at rupees. Clear it up, everybody. This would be the bunch of accounting in this particular case. I am interested only in D1. How many of you got D1 correct? That you should capitalize at 13.75 lakhs. Good, here. Those who didn't get it right, what kind of mistake was made here? என்னமாரி தப்பா பண்ணீங்க? சார் ட்ரையே பண்ணல. ஓகே, அதுவே பெரிய தப்பு தான். ட்ரை பண்ணாட்டி மிஸ்டேக்கே வராது. இன்னும் நிம்மதி. பட் எனிவே, ஆர் வி கிளியர் அபவுட் திஸ் ஒன்? யா, எனி பாயிண்ட் தட் யூ வாண்ட் மீ டு டிஸ்கஸ் ஆர் கிளாரிஃபை எலாபரேட் ரைட் நோ? ஆர் வி குட் டு கோ கைஸ்? எவ்ரி ஒன் ப்ரொசீட் பண்ணலாம். அப்பா, யூ வாண்ட் ஆஸ்க் மீ சம்திங்? யூ வில். தட்ஸ் அன் இம்ப்ளைட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் எலிமெண்ட் தர். அதை வச்சு ஒரு கொஸ்டின் இருக்கு. திங் வில் பி டச்சிங் அப்பான் தேட் ஆல்சோ ஷார்ட்லி. சரியா? See, moment there is a deferment, keep this point in mind. Moment there is a deferment in payment, if the deferment is like 1 month and all, in general we don't consider time value. But deferment is going to extend beyond a year, or you find that deferment anala the so called the price that you pay is also a bit more, we had infer that as a discount rate coming into picture. We had interest eliminate pananungar tharthu. We'll touch upon that. We do have a question shortly. Adhukapra enna question sonna ulladha sonna na. Now that he addresses this particular issue, I think there was a question we had somewhere. You look at question number 25. The page 7 or page 8 and tharla enakku. You write it whatever way. Question number 25, guys. Chariya. On 1st of April 2017, an item of PPE is offered for sale at 75 lakhs, with payment term being as follows. 25 lakhs down payment, 12.5 lakhs per annum at the end of each year over the next 4 years. Property developer is offering a discount of a certain percentage, which translates into an implied discount rate of 6.83%. Show how the property will be recorded in the books. So, in the first point, the actual monies payable for acquisition of property. எவ்வளவு? எவ்வளவு சார் டவுன் பேமெண்ட்? 25 lakhs. இன்ஸ்டால்மெண்ட் 1 12.5, இன்ஸ்டால்மெண்ட் 2 12.5, அந்த லைக் இல்லையா? கரெக்ட் தானே? எவ்ரி ஒன் எஸ். இப்போ டோட்டல் கன்சிடரேஷன் பேபிள் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் டு பி ரூபீஸ் 75. This matches with the fact as given there in the question. Now comes the whole idea. Enna idea kudukuraa? Now, since there is a what? Deferment in payment, the above rupees 75 lakhs includes interest element. The above rupees 75 lakhs will include interest element. Romba logic idana, rendu varsham kaichu tharapora appo irukka porudhu. This is further confirmed that, enna solran yaar, they say that what? The developer is also offering what? Cash discount mari. Seriya? Kuduthirukana illaya? Then they say this translates into a discount rate of 6.83%. So what is 6.83%? This is not the discount percentage, but discounting rate. That is the implied interest rate. Enna parano? Can we capitalize the asset at 75 lakhs? No, we have to capitalize the asset at what you are at? Discounted value of the consideration payable. Why? So discounted value da. Fair value of consideration payable today. So how do you discount? There are 4 cash flows after time 0. Time 0 25 lakhs, no point in discounting. Subsequent 12.5 each should be discounted to present value at 6.83%. That pretty much addresses the very precise point that you were raising right now. Courier there. Yes, can I just quickly make a note and then figure out the answer, guys? Super. 67.5 is the number. I would like you guys to discount and confirm the numbers here. Proceed further, please. சொல்லுங்க சார். சேம் ஸ்டோரி, சேம் ஸ்டோரி. ஹவ் யூ சீன் ஹவு தீஸ் கைஸ் டிபிகலி டூ? 0% இஎம்ஐ இந்த ஸ்வைப் மிஷின்லயோ ஆன்லைன்லயோ வாங்கும்போது யூ சம்டைம்ஸ் செக், யூல் ஃபைண்ட் தட் தி எக்ஸ்டென்ட் ஆஃப் சோ கால் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் காஸ்ட் ப்ரொஜெக்ட் பண்ணிட்டு தட் வில் பி கிவன் அஸ் எ டிஸ்கவுண்ட் அப் ஃப்ரண்ட். அதில் தான் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் கம்ப்யூட் பண்ணுவோம். சேம் தான், சேம் லாஜிக் தான். 40,000 ருபீஸ் ஜீரோ காஸ்ட் இஎம்ஐ அப்படின்னா தென் யூ கேன் நாட் கேபிடலைஸ் 40,000 ருபீஸ் டுடே. ஷுட் ஒன்லி கேபிடலைஸ் 35,000 ருபீஸ் டுடே. ஜீரோ காஸ்ட் அண்ட் இம்ப்ளைட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் தட் ஹஸ் டு பி எலிமினேட்டட். தட்ஸ் ஆல். கிளியரா கைஸ்? எவ்ரிபடி யார் புரியுதாரப்பா? யா சொன்ன சார் ஆன்சர் 67.5 ரைட். யெஸ் கேஷ் க்ளோஸ் டிஸ்கவுண்ட் ஃபேக்டர் 6.83%. திஸ் இஸ் ஸ்லைட்லி மெஸ்ஸி டிஸ்கவுண்ட் ரேட், கடுப்புற டிஸ்கவுண்ட் ரேட். இதெல்லாம் டிஸ்கவுண்டட் கேஷ் க்ளோஸ். So what are the numbers that we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. Ko zero potukku munnadi. So cash flows are 25 12.5 12.5 12.5. discount factor 1/1.0683 power clear. Right, the discount rate kandupidikkum bodhu there is always a confusion, how many decimals? 3, 4 is okay. 2 and 1 and all lazy bum approach. 5, 6 and all you should not be even here at all. You should be working in NASA, not here. All accurate and precise. 3, 4, okay, normal humans can discount rate. So special humans. You are in the class. So anyway, 25, then what are the numbers here? 11.7, 10.95, 10.25, 9.6. So present value happens to be 61.5. Appa enna artham? We should capitalize only rupees 67.50 crores in accounting entry. Entry will be how much here? PP account at R 67.5 to cash or bank account, down payment 25 to financial liability account balance. The financial liability next to 4 years ko potu paarenga, exactly it will become zero. 42.5 plus interest minus installment. அடுத்த வருஷம் பிளஸ் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் மைனஸ் இன்ஸ்டால்மெண்ட் இட் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி ஆட் அப் டு ஜீரோ அட் எண்ட் ஆஃப் யுவர் 4 இயர் டைம் பீரியட். கிளியரா யார் எவ்ரி ஒன்? எஸ் ஸோ பிஃபோர் வி மூவ் எனி ஃபர்தர் அட் திஸ் ஸ்டேஜ் எனி பாயிண்ட் டு வாண்ட் மீ டு கிளாரிஃபை கைஸ். ஸோ கீ ஐடியா ஃப்ரம் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் குவெஸ்டின், வென் எவர் தர்ஸ் அ டெஃபர்மெண்ட் யூ பிளீஸ் வாட்ச் அவுட் ஃபார் தி இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் எலிமெண்ட். அது இல்லாமல் டெஃபர்மெண்ட்டே இருக்காது குவெஸ்டின். ஷெல் வி எவ்ரி ஒன் கைஸ்? ஸோ லாஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தி குவெஸ்டன்ஸ் ஃபார் தி டே கைஸ், குவெஸ்டின் நம்பர் 23. A Limited acquired a building for rupees 8 crores from B Limited, which already had non-moving tenants, immobile tenants. Subsequently, A Limited paid rupees 2 crores as compensation and legal cost to evict existing tenants so that property could be leased out to third parties at higher rates. Advise A Limited on the accounting treatment for the amount. What is this non-moving tenant here? இன்ஸ்டியூட்ல வந்து ஆல்வேஸ் ஹேட் திஸ் நான் மூவிங் டிக்னிட்டரிஸ் ஆன் ஸ்டேஜ். எல்லா ஃபங்க்ஷன்லயும் ஒரு டிக்னிட்டரி சுட் பி ஆன் ஸ்டேஜ், ஒரு ஸ்பெசிஃபிக்கா 1 or 2 பீப்புள் வெரி ஸ்பெசிஃபிக்லி கம்பல்சரியா இருப்பாங்க. தலையே போனாலும் சரி, தே வில் டெஃபினெட்லி பி தேர். அவங்களுக்கோசரம் ஈவென்ட் இருந்தால் வில் பி போஸ்ட்போன்டு. ப்ராப்ளி சம் ஆஃப் யுவர் சீனியர்ஸ் ஹூ ஹேட் திஸ் ஓரியன்டேஷன் ஜிஎம்சி இருந்தால் வுட் பி ஏபிள் டு வாட்ச் ஃபார் தட் ஒன். தட் இஃப் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் ஜென்டில்மேன் இஸ் நாட் தேர் தட் ஈவென்ட் வுட் பி போஸ்ட்போன். Therefore, validation will happen on the 13th day validation நடக்கும். Because next 2 days he will not be in station at all. All fancy things used to happen. But TV news channel, you will find that the same set of buffoons will come for all kinds of discussion. Politics na varuva, kaveri na varuva, English na varuva, communal dispute na varuva, economics na varuva, exchange na varuva, petrol price ku varuva. Eppadi oral vandu ithane panna mudiyum theriyala illa. I mean Superman ku thaatha avala. And the mari you will find some very furniture pieces coming in as panel members in various news channels. You will see that one. Immobile panelist avangala ange da irpa avan. கடைசி வரைக்கும் எங்கேயும் உட்காந்துட்டு இருப்போம். சாவும் போது சேரோட சேர்த்து தான் கொளுத்தணும். பிகாஸ் யூ கேன் லிஃப்ட் ஹிம், இட்ஸ் லைக் ரெடி அஃபிக்ஸ் டு தட் திங். அந்த மாதிரி நான் மூவிங் டெனண்ட் அங்கே தான் இருப்போம், நேர மாட்டோம். நான் மூவிங் டெனண்ட்டை காலி பண்றதுக்கு ஸ்பெண்டிங் சம் மணி அக்கௌண்டிங் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட். கேபிட்டலைஸ் நாட் கேபிட்டலைஸ் நான் மூவிங் டெனண்ட் இஸ் பேசிக்லி பிளடி என்க்ரோச்சஸ் இல்ல, என்க்ரோச்சஸ் சொல்ல முடியாது. தே வில் நாட் வேக் இட். வெரி சீனியர் சிஏ ஹூ இஸ் having an office at a very very special place, and 2007-08 the owners had filed a case against him saying that he was sent a request for vacating that premise in 2003 or 4. 2 years he is not vacating. எனக்கு அப்புறம் அந்த கேஸ் என்னாச்சுன்னு தெரியல பட் ஹி இஸ் நாட் வெக்கேட் அட் ஆல் ஹி சட் உனக்கு என்ன ரெண்ட் தானே வேணும் வாட்ஸ் யுவர் ப்ராப்ளம் ஐ வில் பே யூ ரெண்ட் பட் ஐ வில் நாட் வெக்கேட் யா வெரி சீனியர் சிஏ எஸ் ப்ளீஸ் எஸ் சார் ஷேர் வை இன்கம் டாக்ஸ் ப்ரொவிஷனுக்கும் அக்கௌண்ட்ஸுக்கு என்ன பாஸ் சம்பந்தம் இக்கே நான் மோர்மணி நீ இல்லாட்டி நல்லதுரா இல்ல நீ திருஷ்டி போம மாதிரி சோ நீ எவ்வளவு பேர் திருஷ்டி போமான யாருமே வர மாட்டான் யூ பிளீஸ் வெக்கேட் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் ப்ரொமைஸ் சோ தட் இட் இஸ் ஓகே இஸ் தட் அ ஃபேர் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ஆர் திஸ் எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர் இஸ் நாட் இன்கர்ட் ஆன் தி அசட் தேர்ஃபோர் ஐ ஷுட் ஐ கேபிடலைஸ் பாட்டம் லைன் அவ்வளவுதான் தி நெக்ஸஸ் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் ஒன்லி தட் வே சி லாங் பேக் விஜய் மாலியா ஹீஸ் இட்ஸ் அ ஃபேக்ட் ஹி டிட் திஸ் ஒன் again I'm just asking you what should be the accounting treatment Vijay Mallya used to like invite quite a few guests from world over he's like very flamboyant his father was a very conservative businessman but very aggressive businessman Vittal Mallya is a legend Vijay Mallya is a legend of different type so Vittal Mallya vandu bayangara conservative but very very prompt is very very particular that shareholders money is different from this one visionary andar There was a prohibition in 80s also, 70s, 80s. Vittal Mallya went about buying all these liquor manufacturing companies, bottling plants across the country. The legend on that. He knew that prohibition cannot be sustained for long because government needs revenue and our guys will in any case do this Kalacharam business left, right, center and it will definitely come back. As in, alcohol will be permitted once again, vangi innaru. Visionary na visionary. I mean, you might have reservations about what he was manufacturing and all, but that man had bloody terrific foresight. He passed away and this 25 27 year old Vijay Mallya suddenly became the entrepreneur but adorikku vande flight oduvaran car oduvaran that is all that he used to do appdi solitta but anyway point to be noted Vijay Mallya after he took over he was inviting lot of signatories solitta he said that my office building is not looking nice let me do the entire painting so far so good then he found that en veedu office la nalla da irukku en theru vasangama irukku Therefore, he went and requested other office premises to paint. Paint, but neat out, of course. Those guys refused. Then he said, then I will do. Because this should be very nice, posh, what not. No? He did that. Aim building, idichi kattraen, paint pandraen, capitalize pandraen. Adutham building paint pannadhukku. Road sari illa. I'll go talk to CM, he's not doing. Naane nondi road pottukuren. He will do that, he did that. He did the entire, you know, aesthetic thing and all to ensure that, you know, state wherever he is, like, appealing. Supposing somebody does it that way, capital is expense stuff. That would be expense stuff because the outcome you don't control. Adutha building, you don't control at all. Paint it, like, kalangathale, vatham, pasikindu, panadisi, thuppi utta, nanchipangala, design, decoration, potter, kaapdi, then you don't have any control. So, be very clear, whether you should be capitalizing or not, first and foremost, the expenditure was incurred on the asset that I own, I control angaradhu paakanum direct benefit irukana paakanum adukapra all these kind of other factors you should check in this particular question what's your answer guys definitely we can capitalize because a this is done to ensure that the existing assets value is enhanced earning capacity is enhanced that has to be capitalized but for this you cannot earn you cannot use the asset completely that in itself is an evidence that this is an asset this is an expenditure incurred on the asset for the purpose of asset therefore we can capitalize clear I here therefore final answer guys question number 23 hello sir expenditure incurred on evicting eppadi evict pannaanu theriyadhu adichu varadinaana kaasu kudutha varadinaanu theriyadhu evicting so called non moving tenants should be capitalized since moving out those tenants will increase earning capacity will help the company use the asset to the fullest therefore what capitalize the cost finished so non moving tenants ku allow pannalum you required to capitalize you don't add any single brick to your building but it is indirectly connected to the realizing the benefits out of that building this is what you're supposed to do are we good to go guys yeah so that broadly puts an end to your day's discussion so to come prepared day after tomorrow we'll be once again looking at this pp appo mudichiruvom pp related discussions what are small questions that we have will be completing then முடிச்சுட்டு வில் பி மூவிங் இன் டூ திஸ் டாபிக் கால்ட் அஸ் இன்டேஞ்சிபிள் அசட்ஸ். இன்டேஞ்சிபிள் அசட் இஸ் அ ரிலேட்டிவ்லி ஸ்மால் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட், இட்ஸ் நாட் அ ஹியூஜ் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட், வில் நாட் பி ரன்னிங் த்ரூ தி வே அட் விச் விர் டீலிங் வித் பிபி அண்ட் ஆல். இன்டேஞ்சிபிள் அசட் முடிச்ச கையோட மூவிங் இன் டு இம்பயர்மெண்ட். இன்டேஞ்சிபிள் ஷுட் கெட் ஓவர் இன் அ சிங்கிள் கிளாஸ், இம்பயர்மெண்ட் ப்ராப்ளி ஒரு டூ கிளாஸஸ். ஸோ கம் ப்ரிப்பேர்ட், நெக்ஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் வி வில் பி கம்ப்ளீட்டிங் பிபி அண்ட் மூவிங் இன் டு இன்டேஸ் 38 ஆன் இன்டேஞ்சிபிள் அசட்ஸ். தேங்க் யூ, குட் டே, பை பை.